Some people don't like you to mention certain things. Some people don't want you to say this. Some people don't want you to say that. Some people think if you mention some things, they might happen. Some people are really fucking stupid.
Hit me!
It's the worst of the Opie and Anthony show.
Damn!
Yeah, Master Poe came in. Where is all that stuff that Master Poe brought in? You want to get Master Poe in here?
Master Poe comes in.
Or is he trying to get rid of more bloody geese?
Sprays.
Jesus.
And lotions and hand sanitizers.
This must be the guy that brought all that stuff in, right? Here
yeah.
it is.
Oh, here it is.
All right, here comes Master Poe into the studio, Anthony.
Yeah, Master Poe.
Look at the yellow song alert,
this song gets you pumped. I feel like I could get in the crane position and kick some young blonde boy in the face.
And then just rub him and make him feel better.
Yeah!
Master Poe, so this guy Peter stopped by yesterday? He's on the line, I think.
Yes, I am.
Yeah,
oh,
still there?
Okay. I didn't get the card.
What's the card?
It's for all your janitorial needs. Unita Enterprises. He's the vice president.
Smells good, actually.
And I thought it was some kook that was just sending up sprays and stuff. He sent us up deodorizing spray for Jimmy's ass whenever yep. Jim...
Well, we have the Lysol. Is that
one? Yeah, but here's some Orchard Spice spray if you need it.
Okay.
It's an odor neutralizer.
Great. The hair stuff smells good, the Gojo.
What is this?
Okay.
Luxury foam hair and body wash.
Smell it. It smells really good. It's like girly, but it's nice.
What do you do with that stuff?
Ooh.
What do
isn't
you do
that
with
lovely?
What do you do with the Gojo?
Sir?
Oh, my God. Peter.
And yes.
Peter.
What do you do with the Gojo?
I think he was on a cell phone that didn't work.
Oh.
Well, I guess you use this if you're working in, maybe you work in a garage and you get a little oil on you and regular products don't take it off
for your
that
hair,
easy.
Is it?
Yeah, but Gojo has always been this product. I used to use it when I was on the job site, just for my hands. But it takes grease and oil off of you. So I guess this guy's figuring we're, you know, changing engines in Chevy Novas here in the studio. And just in case we need that. But it does smell. That does smell nice.
I sure like that. I wouldn't mind lathering someone up with it.
Now, do you want to keep the stuff from Peter? Because you yelled at Master Poe.
I didn't yell at Master Poe. Don't. I would never yell at Master Poe. I want to make that absolutely clear, Master Paul. I would never yell at you.
I don't know.
Don't start.
I don't know about that.
What?
I think when Master Paul left the studio, you had some things to say to Master Paul.
I was...
That you said to the door after he left.
Don't even... fuck. Don't even. I
what?
Don't...
What
I'm not even
about?
Making eye contact with hey. Master Paul. You know me, Master Paul.
Anthony.
I would never, ever say anything that would disrespect you.
Mm.
Never.
You sure okay. you didn't say anything as he was bringing all that stuff out of the studio?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. You're an idiot. He's trying to start something that
what did
isn't
you say?
There.
He's trying to instigate, huh?
I said nothing.
I just like to see you sweat.
I am sweating. Do you think I want Master Poe to take
honestly,
out retribution on me for something I never did?
Honestly, I've... Peter, back in line one. We don't need Peter again.
No, thank you for the sprays and bumps and whatnot.
Honestly, Anthony is so polite to Master Poe, it's not even funny.
Of course, he's a nice guy. And he could kill with a look.
You pick your words perfectly when you're around Master Poe.
Master Poe came in. He had the sprays and stuff. And he goes, a listener sent these for you. It's for Jim's ass and stuff. And I'm going, why are listeners sending stuff like this? We don't know where it came from. We have a can of Lysol for Jimmy's ass. And we don't really need anything else. And then he showed me some hand sanitizer. You ever see this stuff? You just put it in your hand. You don't need water or anything. You rub it around. And
that's what I thought that might be.
Well, we do have some of that, too. Right, Master Poe? He brought some of,
yes.
Yeah, I think it's in here or something.
Oh, can I use a little for my hands?
To clear this up, yes. Opie was telling me about the situation concerning the guard downstairs. And I thought that was more important than soap.
Yeah, there
all right?
you go.
So I gave you the information. I told you that Eric has the card. If you're interested... By all means, speak to him.
Okay.
All right, I wanted to make sure.
Are you going to kick the guard's ass for us?
No, I will not do that. However, I'll make sure that he doesn't yell
anymore.
When do
you get to kick ass? When someone, like, hits you first?
No, when someone comes in and physically goes towards me.
That's what I mean.
Well, he's not hitting me.
No, he doesn't hit him. He's not one of those hit me first guys.
Right. He's saying get in the vicinity and attempt it, and you're going to get your neck snapped.
Pretty much. Pretty much.
You can pretty much tell from a guy's look if he's going to be aggressive with you, right?
It's body language and also their eyes. You want to see exactly what they're
about.
Work
together. If he's looking you up and down, looking to scope out where he's going to hit you, you can pick that up in a second.
We'll work together. I'll cover up the security cameras. You do a number on him, and then I'll vouch for you and say that he attacked you first.
That he fell down in a drunken stupor on the floor.
Well, we can do that.
Slipped on Ben's coffee in the elevator.
We can do that, or Anthony can assist me in a self-defense demonstration.
No, never.
I'd like to see
never.
That.
Never. It would never happen. I would lay there and just let you do what you will.
Steve will do it.
Why do I have to do this shit?
That would be wonderful.
That was one of the best things ever on the old show. Who did you take on?
Tito Ortiz. And it wasn't really taking on. Who did I get knocked out by?
Remember Tito Ortiz?
Yeah. Ultimate fighting champ.
Right. And we thought it would be great if Steve took him on.
Just to see how long Steve could actually go with the guy.
Kind of like riding a bull.
Yeah, like riding a bull.
You know, how long could you stay on a bull? So we said, Steve, take on Tito Ortiz. And how long did he last?
12 seconds.
Was it that long?
Well, the thing is this.
I remember you just going down.
Yeah, it was 12 seconds.
And he wasn't trying to hurt you.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the thing. If you fight back, this guy could snap your neck. And that's you have to sort of make a judgment call. Do you fight back, punch him in the face, and risk him tearing your eyes out of your head? And that's... And that's the thing. Yeah. If I go up against him, he knows more kung fu.
Steve, that was the day, though, all kidding aside, I knew you were the real deal. I mean, who in their right mind would take him on, even in a fake fight?
And Steve was trying. Like, he was trying to stay up, and it was, I don't know, it was like watching the mighty Kong fall off of the building.
Yeah, really that was when I was 120 pounds heavier, too. He jumped on my back.
Were you that much heavier?
Oh, yeah. It was before his surgery, right?
And he jumped on my back. The second I went for I did one half-assed wrestling move, took his leg out. In the time that it took me to take his leg out, he was on my back, had me in a sleeper hold, and I could feel my consciousness leap. Consciousness. Thank you,
how much did he weigh?
Oh, he's a big pounds boy. Less. He had to be. Like,
he's big though, right, Tito? He's not a small guy.
230 probably.
Yeah. No, he's.
And he just has those techniques, those grappling techniques, where he can tie you up to where you're just not going to move, and then put a little sleeper hold on you, and you're done.
You guys see? There's a documentary you might have seen it called Choke. It's about
the Yankees this year. No,
no.
Yeah, Hicks and Gracie was in it.
Yes, it's also the Petersons. choke and swim. Yeah, about Hicks and Gracie.
Hoist Gracie.
No, this is Hicks and his older brother.
Oh,
who they say is actually a better fighter.
The whole Gracie family is crazy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are those sleeper holds for real?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. I thought that was just the blood off to your head.
That was just like an old wrestling fake move.
Nah. Well, they do the fake sleeper holds in WWF.
Right. WWE. They show one guy, a little Asian guy, who's probably about 140 pounds, beating this guy who was probably 250. Because like the guy picked him up by his arm. Like the little Asian man was hanging on the arm of the other man like a kid. But he did something with his legs, and he locked the guy's arm. And the guy just patted him immediately because he was about to have his arm snapped by a 150-pound guy.
They can tie you up with their body, and then they start putting a little pressure on a leg or an arm where you got to tap out. You're
done. It's broken.
Right, or it's going to be broken. I've watched those Ultimate Wrestling things where they do snap people's arms.
Jesus.
Jimmy pulled his pants down, and he's showing his ass to Voss out the window.
And what is Voss writing on that piece of paper?
Voss thought all of a sudden it was a mirror when he looked into it and saw an ass.
Oh, it's a piece of paper that says, I love you, Jim.
All right.
Oh, that was funny. In 15
needs
seconds,
attention.
He's really going to laugh.
He needs attention. We'll get him in here in a few minutes. All right, Master Paul.
He thought it was a mirror.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
I want to see you give a demonstration, though, someday, because Voss took karate. He actually did take karate.
That's right. He brags about it sometimes.
Voss, come in here.
What style of karate?
I'm not sure. He probably doesn't even
listen
know.
Listen, karate.
Yeah. It's pronounced karate.
All right, Voss, get over here.
Yeah.
Look at you.
That's
Rich.
That's a solid ass.
Did you sleep in your car?
Look at that.
I slept at for 2 hours around the corner at my manager's
house. Cannot believe you went with Spinal Tap's idea for your DVD.
Is that Spinal
Just
Tap?
Just black?
Oh, yeah.
It's the black album.
First of all, let me explain
Simple.
This.
I actually like it.
But this is Voss, not Spinal Tap. Okay, this is a collector's item.
I'm just saying,
item.
Spinal Tap did the same thing, the black album.
Did they really?
Yeah, they were like, Beatles had the white album, we'll have the black album.
No, I went with the Chicago theme, like Voss 1, Voss 2.
Oh,
I mean,
not
that I could ever
like
get
Chicago,
to 2
right, the band?
Yeah, and plus it's easy to spell.
That is true.
It just says Voss in white lettering and it's black.
Here's the thing. When you're
you don't want to pay for printing, obviously.
No, I could pay. When you go to a record store, dummies, when you put something out that's sellable, it's called the 10-foot rule in a record store. And if you could see over 10
feet. Are you giving marketing tips, the 10-foot rule?
Yeah, I'm giving marketing tips.
Is that how you
tips.
Decide who you're going to blow in a rest area?
Yes.
I look into this and I ask myself, how much more black could it be? And the answer is none. None more black.
But you know what? If you open it up and you see the second thank you, then you will see.
Who's the first?
Who's the first?
Yeah, who is the first thank you?
Jim Norton, I think, is the first.
Aww. Oh, all right.
No, that's, I don't think. I don't know. That's maybe that's sweet. That's under friends.
Open up the brand new Voss DVD to see who he thanks first.
It's black. It's a cool cover. It just says Voss in white. But I don't like the way the DVD symbol in white is on the top left.
We're taking that off.
Yeah, why is that?
You know what? I didn't print them. Here's the thing. We're going to take it off on the next one.
Special thanks to Caroline's Comedy Club is first.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Opie and Anthony.
There you go.
Caroline's has helped you more than Opie and Anthony.
No, it's just a thing. Well, you know, it's...
Last Comic Standing is third.
All right.
And then it really drops off.
Why aren't Opie and Anthony under friends, though?
Where's...
Why aren't Opie and Anthony under friends?
That's right. We're under special thanks. And friends, Jimmy Norton's first.
Oh, look at that.
To my awful friends.
And then Patrice, Keith, Florentine.
There you go.
Colin again. Colin made both... He's a professional and a friend.
You know what?
Just professionals.
But you know what? It would have looked too gay if I would have put you guys twice.
It looks gay no matter what you put, Rich.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know.
All right. Rich, you know karate?
No. Oh, is that what I used to when I was like 20 years ago? Why?
Well, because Master Poe knows a little karate.
Why? What? Did you bring me in here to get my ass whipped again? What's wrong with you guys? I'm not your goddamn punching bag. I'm not your shine boy. Yeah, I used to.
We just wanted a little demonstration, that's all.
Steve doesn't want to
demonstrate today.
What style of karate?
Ugh. Oh, Jesus. First of all, you didn't talk that way when I walked in, okay? You said, pleased to see you, and I'm glad I have a job.
Wow.
Master Poe, you hear that?
Master
Poe. I want to make sure you heard that.
Okay, yeah, Mr. Poe, Master Security.
I wouldn't fuck with Master Poe. That's a bad one.
I wouldn't fuck with
Master Poe. It's me. Poe remarks.
Oh, really? I'm sorry.
Dude, the other day he told a story that he had to get rid of a bloody gi in a dumpster at 5 in the morning.
Yeah really?
And he came up with a story that it was
what
about...
What did he do with the little girl?
Well, we don't know. He told the story, and quite frankly, Norton and I were not sure if we want to believe it or not. We want to believe that
Norton,
it was...
Norton had to get rid of a bloody he a couple weeks ago.
I want to watch Poe behead Voss with his own awful DVD.
Throw it like a Chinese star.
What's like an odd job with a hat. It just goes right through his
man
neck.
Man killed by mediocre DVD.
That's first funny, of all, I'm kidding. Man,
no, the material's great.
Quit staring at me like that because you're making me very uncomfortable. Okay?
Oh, he's just a scary guy.
Look at him. First of all,
very scary guy. His name style? Is Master Poe.
Yeah. What style? Yeah, I never heard of.
No, what style? What style have you taken? Okinawan Kenpo Karate, Shotokan Karate, Shinru Karate. What form?
Ugh, I took Taekwondo, which is kind of like gay street karate, right?
I took gay street karate.
That's a Korean style.
And then I lick them.
That's funny. You got to use that on stage, man.
I got tons of stuff. I'm always on fire.
All right.
Here's the thing.
Why don't you just do a little demonstration?
He's going to help kill me.
Why?
I don't want to see Voss demonstrate, right. Mr. Paul.
Did you tell him what happened the last time I kicked?
How about
you? Oh, the last time he did a kick, but this is true. I forgot. I was dating this British girl, and we're outside of a sushi place. Really good place. And Voss is like, I took karate. So we're like, all right, let's see a kick. So we're standing there, and Rich goes to do a straight kick, and he slips in garbage juice. He falls right on his back. In the middle of 11th Street, Greenwich Street.
I got quick kick. I haven't done it in 20 years, and I got a herniated disc, and I can still kick.
All right,
he'd kill me.
Let's see you kick, at least.
At least see me kick?
Yeah, let's set up
over here, not by him. Here.
Let's set up a Voss kick.
I don't want to see Voss my back.
And then Master Poe can maybe critique it a little bit.
I don't want to see Voss get hurt.
Nathaniel will do a karate...
Does Nathaniel know karate?
Do some moves.
Actually, Nathaniel studies the art of jiu-jitsu.
Does he?
Yes, he does.
How long have you been taking it?
About 2 years.
Okay.
2 years?
Karate?
That's respectable.
Jiu-jitsu.
All right, who do you want to take on, Voss?
Because when someone talks about your hair, you know how to fight them now. You're a mess. Jeez, you got the thinnest hair. You're like 14.
Why don't you
go like Norton to shave it all off and look presentable instead of just like a walking wreck? Hold on.
Hold on, like, you know, dude, your jeans are too tight. To
they really are. Kick. Oh my God, he's gonna kick a nut right into his stomach.
His nut's gonna pop out of his pants.
Please right? don't I mean, fall.
Do the camera.
Please don't. Oh my God.
Wow.
So embarrassing. I've never seen a midget. I've never seen a midget try to karate kick before. Dude.
That's not bad.
Hold on.
Considering Voss is 58.
That's not bad if you're going to be kicking kindergartners in the head.
First of all,
that is true.
I'm out of breath.
He's out of breath.
Your feet have the lift of a tank.
Listen, if I stretch... why am I out of breath after three kicks?
Because you just threw a kick in pants that are too tight for you. There's no reason to be kicking in those pants.
Listen. Why are you wearing the tight pants, man? I'm uncomfortable now. Yeah, I'm uncomfortable for you.
Someone give Voss a scrunchie and socks to pull up over them.
Scrunchie. Master Poe, what did you think of his moves?
He wasn't placing his hip into the kick.
He
hasn't practiced in how many years?
There you go.
Hold on.
How many years?
Later tonight...
Now he just hurt himself. You look like you hurt yourself. Okay.
Later tonight on OpieAnthony.com.
Stop with your nuts in those pants.
We have video of Voss kicking.
That wasn't bad.
Not
a bad kick at all.
That wasn't bad.
That hurt.
Breathe. Jesus.
Yeah. Anybody have any Primatene mist on them?
I'm sure glad you're taking care of that cigarette habit you would.
Huh?
You really got to stop smoking.
Right. I am going to quit.
Master Poe.
Hey, you know who?
I want to see Master Poe.
Is Heffron coming in? Is Heffron coming in?
I think so. I thought he was coming in with you.
Oh, yeah, he's a martial artist too, right?
He's like an Israeli. There he is right there. He's
like an Israeli. All the comics love the kung fu.
Not me. That's because we're scared of our audiences. But no, yes, I used to be really good in Taekwondo years ago. But you know, no master crap, you know? We just fought.
Master Voss.
Yeah.
Master Voss. I like that.
Oh, my.
The karate midget.
Are your legs in pain, or are you...
No, his whole body's in pain. Look at him. He's turning red.
I'm a little out of shape. I'm in good shape, like, on the outside.
I'll say you are.
On the outside, like my...
Yeah, nothing was better than you and Carrot Top taking your shirts off on the
Oh, yeah, did you drop a batch on your stomach watching that one?
I think Carrot Top, I'm thinking Beefcake display.
Buff. Yeah, look at those two guys who are working. Is that what you did?
That was pretty much me.
Look at them. They got a job.
Look at those employed hotties.
So what can we do with Voss and Master Poe?
Not bad.
How old am I?
47. Okay.
47. Right.
So you got a six pack.
You do look good for 47.
How old am I?
How old are you?
Mm-hmm.
Old enough to get a real job and quit messing with me. Ooh. 35.
Oh, boy.
Very good.
How about a little demonstration?
No, he's not going to take my head off.
Master Poe, how high can you kick?
He'll kill me. Look at him. You can tell. Look how confident he is.
Let me see how high you can kick.
All right, well, first of all, kicking will get you in trouble in the street. Okay? You're not supposed to kick high at all.
Right,
that's number one.
No, you gotta higher kick, than the ball.
You got to kick the knee sideways.
You kick below the hips, kick to the shin, kick to the knee, kick to the groin. That's fine. After that, if you kick above that, you're in trouble.
But Daniel kicked in the face when
Daniel
Miyagi told him, taught him the crane move. He kicked in the face.
Yes. No, I know.
Because he got tired.
Yeah? He what?
I forgot what I was going to say. I was going to say something about he was tired of Pat Morita raping him. I'm like, can I please just switch gears once?
See, nobody knows this.
I just want to see a high kick from Master
Nobody Pop. Knows this. Norton years ago used to have a chin, and somebody front kicked him right here.
Oh, is that it?
So, one out of seven isn't bad.
Because that
one
was,
bad one out of about seven?
Here's why I didn't get left, because it was mean and hurtful.
Yeah.
Mean and hurtful?
And I'm very insecure about my chin.
You're not insecure about your chin.
It hurts.
It hurts what? The guy's balls? Oh. Well, it hurts.
All right, one for eight.
It hurts everybody that looks at you. All right, you walking little troll. Did he say last night at the party the only famous people there were him, Voss, and Leary? If you ever put yourself in the same category as Voss and Leary again when it comes to fame.
God. And if you ever address something I said being ironic and sarcastic as real again, I'll throw my coffee on you. I was kind of kidding because I'm a nobody, so I was saying the only celebrities besides me and you, like implying that we're asses, which we are, and then Leary, who has a hit show.
Last night at the party, I'll tell you real quick
Can
before he takes my
that?
Head off.
I liked it. I got to laugh out there.
Here's the only thing fat-free in front of him. Here's the thing.
That's at a great party, visual for radio. Thanks.
It doesn't matter. As long as you guys laugh.
You're not on TV anymore. Yeah,
don't ever move milk in front of me and then go, quiet, folks.
Don't you have some ironing to do?
Last night at the party, real quick, Sam Champion, if you don't know who he is, he's a weatherman.
He's the gay weatherman.
In New York.
Jesus.
Was doing a thing about,
allegedly,
you know,
sure,
stand-up for this festival.
I didn't see him.
And you know, so he's on the mic and he says, you know, this whole stand-up thing is kind of cool. I think maybe I should do it. What do I got to do? And he calls me over and he says, you know, what should I do as a stand-up? I go, well, look, you have stage presence. You have the looks. The only thing you lack is humor. I said that to him, right? And then I'm looking at him going, he's not a bad-looking guy. I'm thinking to myself, you know, if I'm going to leave with somebody, you know what I'm saying, a guy, Sam is my man. That story went nowhere.
Well, we were distracted by the breathing. I'm thinking you might need oxxen.
I'm just trying to get out of
it. What's
wrong
with
him?
What would you have said to Sam if he had milk in front of him?
I say, did you get that from Norton's breast?
Hey, that's good. All right, 2 for 10.
Not 2 for 10. One bad one. One bad one and a bad story.
You've had 2 bad ones and
about 6 good ones.
8 good ones.
All right, not bad.
Can you kick high, Mr. Paul?
Uncomfortable. Well, go a kick. Let me see.
If you don't mind, what I'd like to do is just show you exactly how I'm going to protect you guys. Is that all right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he is a killer.
Get over there, Rich.
You can look at him and tell he's a killer.
He's a killer because he's polite to everyone when they come in. Thank you for coming. We're glad you're here. That's the type of guy that tears your throat out.
Yeah, Voss, get over there. Little demonstration.
Well, I'd rather not do it with Voss because I don't want him to get hurt.
Yeah.
I like him now.
Good. And I think you're funny, by the way. Pretty hilarious.
Thank you.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my...
he is a lunatic.
My student, Marcelino, he's going to assist me.
Now, Voss is very funny. He's just a mess.
No, you're not leaving yet. No. Oh, you have problems? Okay.
That's all right.
So we'll do this real quick. And if you can do me a favor, commentate. Just tell...
Of course, because it's radio. That's our job. We'll commentate. All right, so Master Poe is going to show everybody in the studio how he's going to protect us, Anthony.
Yeah. Just squaring off.
Ben, get the mic near those guys. Master Poe, why don't you explain what you're going to do before you do it? That might help us.
Well, look, it's over there. It's on TV. It's the same thing.
Oh, wow, look on TV. Watch this guy get shot.
They never show him getting shot anymore.
No.
They cut it off right before he takes a bullet to the face, by the way. The cops shot that hostage taker at the Mexican consulate.
Oh, that's what that was?
LA. Yeah, there they go. They shot him in the face.
Oh, is it the face?
Nice.
Is he dead?
Critical.
How'd they get the bullet around her fat ass?
He was a big, awful pineapple whore.
And he was holding a starter's pistol, a fake cap gun.
Oh, he had a pistol?
He had a cap gun.
Oh, man.
It wasn't even a real gun.
See, look at that. In one day, 2 people took it in the face. Come on, that wasn't bad.
I didn't say it was bad. I think you're hilarious.
Oh,
we love you.
You got to do backflips in here? I got some good lines.
All right, here goes Master Poe.
All right, so... basically, what's going to happen is Mussolini will attack me, and...
oh, my God.
I'm not...
I don't want to see this.
Wow.
I'm not going to give you the numbers as far as what I'm going to do.
Uh-huh.
Let's just say he's going to lose.
Okay.
Okay?
Are we aware of hard surfaces that could crack heads open over here?
Oh, man. I used to love being the toughest guy in the studio. We don't even rate anymore. These guys are like killers.
When were you the toughest guy in the studio?
What about Anthony?
I fought 4 people.
No, I'm not putting me as tough guy in the studio, but I think Rick could have kicked your ass.
Rick could have kicked your ass.
No, we fought. He would have held you down and then used your nose to dock with his mule.
We fought. We had a good fight.
You and Rick fought?
Yeah. We did Fight Club.
I don't remember that one.
He got the best of me in the end, but I held my own, and then I beat up Frenchie really bad.
Frenchie.
Yeah, Frenchie.
The judge's toughest guy in the studio. Oh.
And then I
souffle kicked his ass in the kitchen one night.
I gave Paul Bond a nice black eye.
He surrendered to Jeremy Coleman one day.
Oof.
Norris was the toughest guy.
Yeah, Norris was definitely
part of the show.
The animal that came into the studio.
All right,
bulldog.
Well, you know what I was saying. Yeah. We used to feel like we were men. We're not anymore. I mean, look at these guys.
No, we're cared for.
We're cared for. We used to be able to think we could take care of ourselves, and that's the point I'm making. We can't.
How long have you been training? You've been training for a long time, too, right?
2 years.
I'll give him some ear.
Oh, my God. These guys are really getting into this.
Is that your defense, like a skunk boss rubs behind his ear and shoves it under someone's nose?
Oh, are we going to do that today?
I got some, probably. I think I say some up.
Oh, don't nice. Waste it.
Who's going to take it today?
Huh? One of the interns. Who hasn't?
All right. I think I got some.
Yeah. You think you got some good stuff?
I think I got some saved.
We'll do that after the break. All right, go ahead, Master Poe.
By the way, Marcelino is one of my top students. Although he hasn't said anything to you guys, he is.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm glad I didn't say
that. Oh, he's a really real student?
Look at him getting ready.
I know.
Oh, my God. These guys aren't messing around. I thought this was...
He's getting ready for the pain.
I didn't know he was a real student.
Oh, man. Oh, jeez.
All right, they're shaking. He's taking
flashlights and cell phones.
Anything
off
that
of
can impale him.
Student.
Oh my God! I don't want to see this. Are we filming this for opieandanthony.com? All right.
Oh boy.
All right, Master Poe.
Oh my God!
Oh man! It's over in a second.
All right. You know
Holy
what?
Holy shit!
Holy. You know what?
Yeah.
And it's got him down.
Wow. Oh yeah! Bravo.
That was nice.
That's
holy shit.
Oh my. All right.
That guy would just be like, if that was full contact, he would just be dead.
We can't even describe it. That was just insane.
It's a slow punch. It's not a slow. It's a punch to the face that Poe kind of steps out of the way at, winks at us, and then just begins chopping the guy's neck. It's
And then
horrifying.
He just hacks at every part of his body in a split second.
When he smacked his ass.
God. Oh, he's breaking his arm.
All right. All right. I can't look at that.
Ow!
And this is just a demonstration. I can't even look at that. That's
Don't hurt him. Master Poe, don't hurt his arm like that.
Oh, my God.
Master Poe, don't hurt him.
Someone wake up Master Poe. Someone wake him up.
Reading bosses.
Get Master Poe back to reality.
To get him more angry.
Master Poe, how do we wake him up?
Master Poe,
wake up! Master Poe!
I understand, Master Poe.
Get out of the zone.
Oh, God!
All right, don't snap his neck.
He's tapping out.
All right, he tapped out.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
All right, no, I think we're done.
No, that's good. That's good.
That's good. Oh, my God. Wow, you got to see the video.
Holy.
Master Poe goes to another place. He just zones out.
Yeah, it was great.
Thank you, Master Poe.
Bravo.
Now, Ben, what you were saying.
There goes Master Poe.
Oh my God. Very good. Very good.
That was
Bravo.
My God.
Bravo.
He's for real, man.
Imagine trying to get like a punch in edgewise. It just wouldn't happen.
Because your arm, you look at the punch as an aggressive thing. He's like, oh great, this extended limb can be snapped.
Of course. And then, like, when the guy goes and attacks him, all he does is totally disables your arms. He's like hacking at your arms. And then if you think you're getting out of the way of that, an elbow will hit you in the face. And then he'll grab the arm and twist it right off. And then he grabbed his head and started twisting it to where he
it was a demonstration, and Mars was definitely, like, in pain.
Well, he knew he was getting ready for pain, too, because you could see he was just like, ugh.
Yeah,
I've
know this
done
move.
This before,
this
and I know what
ugly.
It's like.
Oh,
what
I really have to apologize for being mean to
no
him.
No kidding.
Oh, man.
That guy's a killer.
We've been saying it.
Oh, my
He's
God.
The real deal.
That's
he comes in the other. One of the interns rats him out the other day and comes in here and goes, guys, I saw Master Poe putting a bloody gi, which is what, the karate top or whatever, into a dumpster at 5 in the morning. So we had to bring him in to ask him what that was all about. And then he told us a story about his dog being in a dog fight and taking the dog to the hospital. And he told it so seriously, he goes, do you really want to know what happened?
I'm like,
I guess. So he tells this story about his dog.
No. Do you want to know the whole truth, the real truth or something?
Yeah. So then Norton and...
Oh, did Norton spray one of his defenses?
Yes, he did.
Norton and I go to breakfast after the show, and we talked about it for like 10, 15 minutes. We're like, are you buying this story or what? I mean, there's part of our brains thinking, is it real or not?
There's some dead student somewhere.
Someone who's check bounced.
Efron's a karate. He's like Israeli karate. He's pretty tough, too.
Yeah, Efron took it for a long time.
Yeah, I know. I guess with that act, you'd have to have karate.
Efron's hilarious.
Well, I know. He's funny.
We're going to get him in here next. All right?
Oh, man, that was some scary looking.
Wasn't that scary?
Don't want to kick like doing it. Yeah, I did it 20 years ago. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, throw a kick at it. Your leg would be out of the socket.
Because even if you got it through,
your move was so
bounced.
Cute. Yeah. compared to what he was doing. Wasn't it adorable? You had such an adorable little karate kick.
Oh, I want to put ribbons in my hair.
Go to the strip mall and you see the little kids in there doing their first karate kick.
It's like watching the cute little kids through the window of a Tiger Shulman. And there's
I think that kick could have broken a piece of balsa wood. It was nice. Jesus. I mean, honestly, it was sort of impressive until I saw that guy. Oh. And then it puts it in perspective there. It was cute.
He's into that hand-to-hand combat shit where he wants to grab you. Yeah, normally, you want to just kick and run.
Pungy stick fight.
You guys want to hear...
A sharpened stick.
Oh, yeah, he's a weapons master, too. Yeah.
Sticks, knives. He's crazy. He'll do a knife fight, and you'll just be cut up on the floor.
It's the kind of guy you want to hang out with, though.
Of course it is.
Yeah, so you can rest assured we're getting him to the Hammerstein in case there's any problems.
Don't you want to go to a bar with him and just go to the bar and go... Hey, asshole, move. Yeah.
Can you and that fat whore wife of yours get out of my way?
And meanwhile, it's the biggest guy at the bar. You just walk up to him and go, hey, dick, move.
Mm.
Oh, let my friend Master Poe take care of you if you have any problems with me telling your
it's the look that he
pig
gives,
wife to get out of the way.
No one's going to mess with him just because of that look he gives.
Like, with guys like that, I never talk shit to other people. Like, when I'm at Club Soda
you
Kenny,
don't know.
No, just because, like, if I'm with Club Soda Kenny, I know he would defend me. And I
with
also know he's a psychopath, and he would kill somebody. It's like, you don't want to get the guy you're with on a murder rap.
Right, that's why I always go, nah, it's cool.
I would walk away.
Now,
I would,
you don't know who has a gun, too, though.
Yeah, Kenny.
You think he's a psychopath? He's 6'5 and skips down the sidewalk.
He's 6'5, he skips, and he's also a 20-something year martial artist.
I would defend Your Honor if we were in a bar.
Voss, you defend it with your mouth, though. Don't talk about him.
Don't hurt him.
I'll do whatever it takes.
Oh, no.
You guys want to hear The Silence of the Lambs
Yes.
song? Yes. Oh, we got a break. I had this song in my head all night long. Maybe that's why I didn't sleep.
Put the fucking lotion in the basket.
Yeah. Put the effing lotion in the basket. Buffalo Bill and Catherine. We're going to get these guys on the show in the very near future. Steve found them.
He did.
Yeah, it's these two guys from California. They did the Silence of the Lambs, the musical.
It's great.
And they're sending us a better copy, matter of fact.
Nice.
Because we got this off the internet. And they send great files over the internet, don't they now?
Fucking poodle in the trash.
Dude, I could not stop listening to the replay I heard last night. I caught it. It was great.
Oh, let's listen to it again.
Boss
is
doing some karate moves. Want Master Poe back in here? And you could
do them on myself.
What was that,
he's doing karate moves with a pack of Marlboro in one hand and the lighter in the other.
Oh, brother.
Oh.
All right, let's check this song out.
Master Nicotine.
Voss is Master Poe.
Voss doing those Sully height kicks that he was doing before. Reached the top of Sully's little head.
Speaking of Godsmack, they're going to be in the studio maybe within the next few weeks doing a little acoustic set for us, and their DVD's out. It's great. We have Martini Steve back in the studio.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he was observing Master Poe during the commercial break. What was going on?
That little... sorry.
Martini Steve.
Uh-huh.
So annoyed.
Really. Just wish it would go away.
A lot of the listeners are with you on that show, but tough shit.
Yeah, all right. That little display from Master Poe and Mars was no bullshit. There, he's out in his cubicle, or he was during the break, decompressing. He's in a zone.
Yeah.
And if Mars hadn't tapped his leg like he did, he would have kept going. He would have kept going until Mars' arm snapped.
That's what he does. He keeps going. You got to tap out. And then when he's done, he had to go to his cubicle and, like, wind down, or he'd just stay in this
destructive mood.
You see it in his eyes. Yeah. He goes to another place when he's doing that stuff.
Eric asked him about some paperwork or something, and Master Poe was like, just give me a minute. Give me a couple of minutes. And he shut his eyes and just kind of breathe and... calm down.
Where the hell did XM Satellite Radio get this guy from?
He's fantastic. Yeah.
It's like a trained assassin.
He has to come to events and everything. There has to be one listener he can strangle.
Wouldn't that be great to see? Just see that
a
in
listener,
in full
screw that.
Contact.
How about a staff member?
Imagine that in full contact.
Yeah.
Watching someone just get put down in a second.
But even that play stuff, he really hurt Mars's hand.
Play, that was no play.
Well, I mean, you know, the half-assed punch Mars threw, he blocked it with his elbow, and Mars smashed his arm right
into
it.
I've heard that these guys practice during the whole show.
Yeah, if you watch during the show, they go off into Poe's office, and Master Poe's office, and they'll just start sparring with each other, and they'll really, really do semi-full contact stuff until they're both winded and hurt.
There's all kinds
of stuff.
But
Poe is his instructor.
Here. Yeah.
You know what? When we clear out this whole studio, and we have all that open space... outside, we ought to put a little section over there where we can have a mat.
I don't want to see it.
A heavy bag something.
No way.
We get Taylor Loy in here or someone really hot like that, and you say if you can put Poe down, this girl will blow you.
Hey, you get taken.
That's a bad idea.
That's right. And then watch me take a swing at it. Catch my beating like a man, then receive my Hummer in the
hospital. Let's get John Heffer on in here, man.
Yeah, bring him.
You know somebody too will try to test him after they hear that.
Of course.
You know, so you know what
Tyson
with the person
there's
so much
try
to test. Do you think against a boxer like a pro, like who would win? You think like that, you know, the Master or like a say a Golden Glove?
No, boxers are really only for their own environment.
Yeah,
you take them out of that, and you know,
Gracie and those guys murder boxers. Cause they just grab you by the legs or by the arm and twist your
grapple
arm
you up,
by,
and then
awful.
Twist your arm out of its socket.
Won't
like
Gracie
a turkey
like
leg.
Not Gracie like won't punch at first until he gets you down? Like that's the thrill of it for him. Is like he doesn't want to punch. He won't throw a punch at
He'll
your face.
He'll tie you up
so
you can't move. They get on you like a web, and you're just stuck there. And then they take an elbow and just start pounding your face in with an elbow. It's great to watch. Oh. I love those.
Grishy
Ultimate
Allen?
Fighting. Grishy I hear Allen. You're pretty good, too. That's what I hear.
No, I suck. But I love it, though. I'm like a fan.
Are you
You know
a
what
fan
I mean? Like,
it?
I know all those guys in Gracie and Boss Root and Tito Ortiz, all the huge UFC guys and stuff like that. There was a point where the Gracies used to be able to beat everyone's ass because nobody knew how to ground fight.
Uh-huh.
Right? Those guys would take a punch, and then they'd end up screwing you on the ground. But now,
on the floor,
it's kind of evolved to the point where now people kind of know how to ground fight and you know, jiu-jitsu doesn't necessarily always win.
So there's other people that are kicking
their ass. Yeah, jiu-jitsu's great if you're in that type of environment. You're at a bar, and let's say I'm a black belt in jiu-jitsu, and I'm going to, you know, take your elbow and somehow put it through your rectum and out your mouth, is good if you didn't go to the bar with a buddy of yours. So why I'm doing that to you, your buddy is teeing off on my face and, you know, stomping me into
true.
The ground.
That's true.
The
bar fight things, usually there is a buddy involved.
Yeah, so, I mean, there's, you know.
Mm-hmm. But can't those jiu-jitsu guys, they can also punch real quick, too. I mean, like, they can wrap you up, but they can also snap your arm real quick and then go about their business to your
and
friend.
Get your buddy.
Yeah.
Well, what's the difference? Isn't that like Hapkido, or isn't that what he just did?
Hapkido?
Yeah, Hapkido, what? Right?
There's Hapkido. There's Aikido. Then there's Hapkido, which is Korean. Which is using the persons that... Why am I talking like Danielson?
Do you know Gracie's personally? You know those people like...
Not personally, no.
You think the Ultimate Fighting guys are telling jokes right now somewhere?
Yeah, right.
I just don't like the fact that Voss is asking fourth grade questions. Are they personal friends of yours?
Yes. I'm just setting them up so you can get a picture with them, okay, stupid? Okay? I'm just looking out for you so you can run behind them with your camera.
But who do you think would win? God or karate expert?
No, honestly, in a race, if it was between Kit and Herbie the Love Bug, which one would win?
How long did you take it for?
I've done what I do for like maybe 2.5-3 years. But the problem with what they don't incorporate in the training is guys who stay out to four and booze.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're eventually, I don't care how good of a martial artist you are, if you smoke and drink, you're done in about 90 seconds just because your body's going to go, no, dude, you're a tool. You don't take care of yourself. I'm going to make sure nothing works.
Yeah.
And also, the toughest guy always wins. I will completely tell you, I'm a huge wuss. As much as I spar and stuff like that, I don't have that thing inside of me that I'm not a
the
mean...
The fight thing.
Yeah, I don't have that mean guy thing, right? Where guys who don't even know how to fight, that just maybe their dads weren't around enough for them.
We saw that when you cried on TV.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So there you go. I cried on TV.
Did he really cry?
What show was it?
Yeah, that's what it was. I was trying to get the soccer mom's vote on the...
Last comic.
What show was that?
On the second season.
Everybody, the second season.
Yeah,
everyone
second
watched
season.
The first season.
And the second season, you had to cry
to win
or advance.
Oh, is that it?
It's the only house that had a lifeguard in it. They cried so much.
Second season was very popular.
Shut up. I'm talking.
I like the second season of Last Comic Standing.
It was very popular.
It was nice.
I cried, but now I'm independently wealthy, so I will take the tears and the ridicule. And then next week, I'm buying a Lexus Cash.
Now you can cry still because of 1951 Mercedes.
Start crying.
Well, I should cry. I'm a Saturn. Faggot sedan. Here's your Saturn, sir. Thank you.
That's fine. All right.
Boss's Reggie, he had to trade it over from, it said Adolf Hitler on it.
I'm going to get another one now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
A new one?
Yeah, well, I'll probably get like a 2001 or something.
You like the classics.
I can't buy a new Mercedes because I'm a Jew, so I'm not going to put money back into their economy.
So you think buying it used...
Buying it used, it's already paid for, so I'm like putting money back into the economy.
Really?
See what
is
I'm
that
saying?
What that is?
Yeah, yeah.
Not realizing that once somebody sells it to you, they're going to go out and spend 90 grand on a new
one.
On
a brand new one.
So you're putting not only the 40 you'd probably spend on a new one, but the 90 that they're going to spend. So you're putting a lot more back in the German economy.
He'd be one of the guys that pull the dead bodies out of the gas chamber. And, you know, I wasn't putting them in. I'm just clearing them out.
Oh, no. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Making room for the new ones.
Or
no?
Couldn't you spend 30 on, like, an F-10 pickup and
there
give it to
go.
People in Tennessee?
U.S.
What's
of
an
A.
F-10? No, I'm a Mercedes truck. Driver. I'm a headliner. I can't be driving a pickup. I'm going to look good. I'm a big act. Are you kidding me?
You really getting a Lexus?
Mm-mm.
Oh. I really want a nice new car.
I told you to get a nice. I told him. I said, look, you're doing well. He's, you know, he was selling out theaters.
Uh-huh.
This creep was
we
selling
remember.
Out theaters.
Until we fucked it up for him.
Yep.
He still did all right after you guys. It's not like you guys were the only thing in the world. You know, we have other things going
yeah,
on.
Yeah, no, you're right. They weren't the only thing in the world when I was in Orlando doing 50 people on a Thursday night. No, you're right. Who needs these two?
It's so funny. His middle name.
25 of them comped.
Radio station comps.
His middle name should be Stepping Stone. He didn't even talk to Colin last night at Colin's farewell party. He knew Colin was gone.
Because I don't know what a farewell... I said it right.
You said it right.
I meant to mock once and I said it right. Because you said a farewell party. And I'm like, I don't even know what a farewell party is. Oh, yes, I do. It's a farewell party.
A farewell party.
Jerry Falwell's party? What?
So, were you pissed? I gotta ask half a question.
Oh.
Were you pissed because you won season two,
mm-hmm.
You know, and there's all that cash out there, and then they rush right into season three? Were you kind of mad that, like...
No time to bask.
Yeah, it sucked.
Right.
It sucked because I was offered, not a lot of television, but more television than I've ever done before. But they said I couldn't do it because it would give me an advantage on season three. So that kind of got crapped on. And then they made me do season three. Yeah. And even a prom queen gets to be the queen for a year.
Yeah,
you know
got
mean?
Nothing.
So, yeah, I really didn't want to
do
season. I didn't want to do season three. So, yeah, I was
kind of
bummed.
They just wrecked that franchise by throwing that third season out there.
Yeah, plus,
too bad.
Yeah, with me, it was a tough call because you're like, I'm like, well, I don't want to do it because I'd kind of rather do, some other shows to kind of, but then they said, well, you're not allowed to. So then it's a tough call. You go, well,
Jesus.
I'm going to turn down national television. Right. I mean, I'm not at that level yet, but on the same token, I probably should have or wish I could have.
Wow.
You could have turned. You know what?
Blows.
I mean, I
in
probably could have. No, I could have said, yeah, but, you know, it's tough to go, yeah, dang it, I'm going to not do primetime NBC.
Right.
I'll show
you. Yeah. But in your contract in the second season, couldn't you have said, if I win, I had the stipulation not to do season three?
Oh,
did I say stipulation?
No, you said contract.
I said contract.
Contract. It's a thing you sign and then eat if you have a cold.
Contract. What did I say?
Contract.
Tiny little time release paperwork.
Whatever. You can't. Listen, it's just a word.
Really, people put too much emphasis on words. Really, you know?
That's it. Boss just diffused the whole thing. It's just a word.
It's just a word. Boss makes me laugh.
Hey, you know what? I'll tell you what sucks. At least Heffron, people know, everybody knows who he is. He won, and season two was a big hit. On season three, they didn't even show the winner. They canceled last episode.
Canceled the show
people come up to
the
me.
Last episode.
Yeah, who won? I forgot.
People come
Alonzo.
Up to me and say,
right,
well, they'll
Alonzo.
Come up to me at shows and go, who won? And I go, I did. Right?
You might as well. Sure.
They don't know. Alonzo, you know, I mean, listen, to cancel last episode, he would have made more money in clubs with people knowing he won.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. He got hosed, too. People not knowing.
But they still know you, though, man. You're still doing good. They all know you from the season two.
From season two. Yeah, you know, even people who came on and saw me would go, you're on season three? Yeah, you don't watch? No. It's different. Yeah, I'm not complaining. You
it
know
was
I mean?
Too much. It was like, yeah, you get season one, season two, and then they threw in that lame season three. It was right. It was too much.
That was the network, I think, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of like probably finishing yourself off and continue to watch the porn. It's just dumb.
Yeah. There's really no reason for it.
You need to just stop and set it away for when you're in the mood again.
Right.
Yeah, that's how I do it.
That
I usually,
might be 20 minutes later, but I, yeah, you know, it's got to be some kind
but
of...
But if you keep watching it, it's a waste.
Yeah.
And nobody enjoys
Completely.
It.
Completely.
Nobody.
You want to go?
Their season won 50 grand every week.
What
just
was that?
Spanking season two won 50 grand every week. Spanking season one, just you know, one there was one week.
What? I don't know. I swear to God, I don't. I'm not even making. What did
you know,
say?
It's just these earphones. You should hear myself.
You should have saw the. Look
I'm trying to follow. You said something about season, 50 grand a week.
50
grand.
Season two won 50 grand a week against season one. On season three, it was head to head competition. Head to head, as in not you know,
right?
As in competing. And they won 50 grand every week. And this is how many. This is how popular season two was.
Yeah.
That one week, Ralphie, Dave, Dat, me, like the four most known from season one, went up against, you know, and they still beat us for 50 grand.
Mm.
I'm just saying. I think listen, Dat you guys were the ones who brought up the dumb show. I
I'm
didn't
not,
bring
I'm
it up.
I'm listening. I just didn't know what you were saying.
You know,
I season think Dat Fan brought all of us down, is what it was. Yeah. Brought the average of the whole first season down.
Oh.
How you were second place to that?
I wasn't second. I was third. Ralphie was second.
Sorry.
Yeah, but you know what? He's only a
sorry,
kid.
I thought you were second.
No, Ralphie was.
Ralphie?
Oh, you did come in third.
I came in third. Who cares?
You should have won. Of those three, Ralphie's funny, but you should have won. Dad, I don't care about, but you should have won.
Every season I should have won. I'm the biggest veteran on those shows. What, are you kidding me? I mean, the kid's all right over here. Alonzo's okay. But
this
I
kid's
mean,
all
no,
right.
He's not a bad guy.
You know,
he's all right. He's a likable. He's funny. I like his energy and stuff. But shit, I'm a fucking legend, okay? I've done a lot of shit in this fucking business. Def Jam, Rosie, yeah. I've done it all. You know, these guys, they
Def
do
Jam,
what?
Def Jam, Rosie?
Yeah, I did from Def Jam to Rosie. I hosted Woodstock. You know, this isn't some fucking just because I was in a contest. Yeah. You know, it's Rich Voss. I went to the contest as Rich Voss.
I've been to several comedy clubs where they're actually the Caesar salad is called the Rich Voss Caesar salad.
I'm telling you.
Rich Voss.
And you're right, and they spell it wrong.
Yeah. And that's how you determine if you made it as a comic, if you get some of the munchies. You know. Named after. I'm looking for the heifer and chicken tenders.
You know what I mean? That would be a proud moment.
That the MC has to plug. Yeah.
God, I wish I could think of something funny to connect with a comic to food. But
Norton's known after the scallop because he's boneless.
You didn't have to explain why. No one is looking at me going, why would he say scallop? Norton's got four abs.
There's no bone in that. That's odd.
And they known know after known after the scallop.
Oh, am I known after the scallop? That's right, I'm post-scallop.
John, you want some Jägermeister?
I was looking at that.
That's the real deal, yeah.
I was told that, but is it plugged in?
Oh, we got
that's cold.
I don't think I could do Jäger.
You want to do a shot?
It ices it up to 5 degrees.
5 degrees.
Where's your show? What time is your show?
Oh, tonight?
Yeah.
Be at like 11 at night or 10 o'clock is at Caroline's. There's like two shows tonight because there's some other thing going on because of the comedy
festival. Okay.
Then there's a sex show. Last time I did Jäger, I think it was Jäger's that one booze, you know, if you do too much where you know at the end of that night you go, I probably took a day off my life. Jäger's one of them. I passed out in a stall of a bathroom with Jäger once.
Jägermeister's the Black Death.
And if I smell it,
alcohol like whiskey or booze.
It's like a liquor. It's almost licorice.
I love the people at Jägermeister, but it's not one of my favorites.
What is it, Lance? Like Zambuca?
Huh?
It's like Zambuca.
No, it's
licorice is the best way to.
Yeah.
And usually the people doing Jäger have the words Abercrombie and Fitch written on some part of their body with shell necklaces.
Right.
Still very good. I mean, but it's like a college drink. But nah.
Yeah, definitely.
And then, but then school. Some people still do it. I don't want to bust
the
people.
A lot of
gave
people
me the
still
Jäger.
Do it. I remember the worst drink was tequila, though.
Tequila I'm a huge tequila fan.
Man.
I'm little, but I can drink a lot of tequila.
I woke
I like
up on the floor of the bathroom at home one day. It was, you know, one morning. You just wake up and go, why the hell am I on the bathroom floor?
No.
And then you all start slowly coming back to you. Yeah, I remember kind of coming in. I remember that. Oh, tequila. A lot of shots. And then you're just horrified going out and looking where you're and how your car was parked.
Yeah, mine was.
Like, oh,
I've been doing this thing a lot lately. Coke.
Oh, yeah.
You guys try that? Yeah. I'm relatively new to it. But
Do you snort it or smoke it?
I snorted.
That's pussy. Listen to me. To be a good coke addict, you gotta like sell your mom's stereo and suck a cock. Then you know that you're doing coke.
You're such a good addict. You forgot the stereo, but you sucked the cock in recovery.
In recovery.
I'm sober 3 years, but what the hell?
You used to smoke it, Rich?
Oh, yeah, Freebase? What are you kidding me?
Where did you get
it? I would get mad watching people that snorted it because it's like reading a book backwards. It is. It's like, you know, I can tell you one time I go, I mean, this is a light one. My friend, I go, do you really think you're going home with those new sneakers, you know, and that coat, you know? Get rid of it. We're selling it. You know,
you would sell your clothing.
Oh, Voss was the real deal. When
is this a real story?
Oh, yeah. Voss used to be.
I got more Coke stories than.
Oh, I didn't know.
Then fucking, what do you call it? One time, someone, okay, I owe these drug dealers money, so they torched my mother's car. Like, they just burnt her car.
Is this,
right?
That's real?
Yeah, they torched her car because I owed them money. I said, you know, so I called them. I said, look, now not only do we get insurance, I'm not giving you the goddamn money. Right, so she goes out and gets a new car, right, and I have it, and she lets me in New York, so I'm driving, and someone smashes into it, right, so and just wrecks the whole side, and I go to that person, look, just give me $100, and I'll let you go, and they gave me $100, and I just went and copped 10 vials, and I told my mom, I don't know, somebody hit your car, parked on the street.
Oh, man, you let him go for $100.
Hey, listen, when you're going to cop, and you're going over to GW, and once you get over and you got another 100 for, you know, plus what you take out of the other people's vials that you're running in for.
Of course you know, take, I used to take a little for yourself.
You dip out of every single one. Oh, man. Oh.
They must have seen you get out of the car with that awful long hair and, oh, this junky motherfucker. Here's $8. Okay.
Oh, the pictures we saw of him with the jerry curl and the bad teeth and everything?
You know the fake, how they had those fake $50 bill advertisement bills?
Yeah, you'd see him laying on the ground and go, what's this? And
we used to wrap, like, 10 singles around it. I'd pull up on the guy and I go, give me 6 vials, and I'd count it like this away from him, and I hand it to him and just drive away, give him the fake 50. One time I tried to grab it out of his hand and he punched me in the face twice. This is a true story.
Oh, wow.
I snatched it out of his hand, right? He punched me twice in the face, and I'm going, oh, did he? So I drove away. This is true. And I opened my hand. I had like 3 vials. I got him.
Oh, you got it.
So I'm all excited. This is true. I pull down the street, right? And I get like 2 miles down the road. I throw in the pipe and I hit it, and it was soap. Right? Oh.
The son of a bitch got you back.
I pull it back. I look, you don't rip me off when I'm ripping you off. Right? What's the deal?
No honor. No honor.
But why would he punch me in the head twice for stealing soap?
Because he could have sold that soap. Yeah. Right? It's on principle.
Wow. I'm new to the whole drug thing. Like, I wasn't a big druggie.
Yeah.
But then I've had a couple nights recently because of the stress. And this is where I decided I'm never doing it again. I was doing, and you know, now I look at the tops of the toilet paper holder every time I go into a stall. Because, you know, before I was naive, I'm like, what takes dudes so long? You know, just hurry up and piss. But I realized that that's where they're doing their lines and stuff. And I was so screwed up, I looked on the floor, because I was totally out, and looked on the floor and I saw a bunch of white stuff. I'm like, oh, somebody brushed it off. And it fell on the floor, but there's a crap load there. And I went down there and took my finger and went like that.
Oh, man.
And I whatever. And it was, like, cleaning. You can tell it was Clorox,
Ajax,
you know, like
or
Ajax
something.
Or something like that. And I went, okay, I probably have a problem. And then I messed up. So I was a drug addict for maybe 2.5 weeks.
If you're snorting coke from the floor, that isn't even
that's
coke.
Bad. That's a bad sign.
That like, is really
you might be
bad.
A drug addict.
You might be a drug addict if.
If you're
seen
a sucking
this,
cop.
If you've seen this act more than once and laughed, you might. I see a bumper sticker coming.
We used to, me and my brother used to sell out of the house, and the people that would come to the door with everything. You know, I have stereos. One guy brought a huge, you know, from the water coolers, the big bottles of water that you put in a water cooler full of pennies on a hand truck. And he's banging on the door. It's like 2 a.m. Guys, like, what? No, you got to cash. We need cash. We need cash. Can't be taking that. Stereos, cars, anything.
I just maybe thought of an internet company you could start, maybe called E. What's not zoning?
eBay.
Funny. No, kind of like eBay, but where people can give up stuff just to get drugs.
Oh,
so
like
you don't bid for it. Yeah,
like a barter system.
Yeah, where people
where you
can just sign up
that big jug full of pennies for cocaine.
Yeah, and then you send it to them.
Oh.
That might work.
Rich, it would have been funnier if I could have remembered.
By the way,
I was thinking like E. Jonesing.
We were with you though, man.
Yeah.
We went with it for a while.
It was there for a little
bit. I was banging. I'm like,
we're like, sounds like.
Need a little more help here.
I fell short.
Boss, when did you decide to get help? Was there one story where you said,
I could tell you a story. If you got 1 minute, I'll run through this quick.
We have an hour and a half.
I'll try to run through this.
The burning mom's car wasn't the problem.
No, this is a true
story. God, your mom, did she hate you for that?
Well, you know, I'm her kid. How could she? I was her favorite. Because my brother and sister were really fucked up. Here's the thing.
How could they be more fucked up than
I'm
that?
No, I'm just kidding. I was real. Here's the deal. Well, I'll tell you a couple. So one time, I'll tell you the bottom story.
No, tell us a couple, and then finish.
Well,
one time,
I called my father. This is not even a bad story, but just at like 3 in the morning. No, maybe at like 11 at night. And I call him. I go, can I come over? And I get to it. I go, can I have $20? I got to get a gallon of paint right at 11 o'clock at night. I told him I need a gallon
of paint. A gallon of paint.
He obviously,
he's looking at his son all drunk.
He obviously wasn't buying it, right?
I had a painting, but here's the bottom story. The real, it was like 7 o'clock. I had no money. Someone calls me. I go into New York for him. I cop whatever, and I come home. I end up with six vials of crack. I smoke them all by 10. Then I go back in, right, with my other friends. This is true. As we're going in, we're going down Route 1 and 9 in like a Z100 or whatever. Come out, whatever. I'm not lying. So we just wipe the car out, spin, take down one of those metal light posts. The big on 1 and 9, all the wheels are off the car. The car's crushed, right? None of us are hurt. We run, report the car stolen, and take another car in. So that's my second trip. You know, and I do like maybe 5 more vials and come back out.
Oh,
now wait, now I'm like, now I'm going to pick up a friend of mine who's a comic. Now I'm going to go pick up my friend who's a comic at the airport, right? I pick him up. We go in the city. He cops heroin, and I cop like 5 more vials, right? Because he had money. I didn't have any money at all the whole night. This is my third trip in now from Jersey back.
Can't even get a cab today.
How are you getting the vials with no money?
The first one, I went and copped for somebody, so I made money, you know, to do it. The second one, my friends were going in, and they were treating, and it was like, you know, 4 or 5 miles to hang out. Just to hang out. I took them to the spot, too. I was taking them to...
I treat people for lunch. Yeah. Jesus.
Yeah, right?
So now the third trip... What the fuck? This is true story. The third trip, we go in, we caught like, you know, maybe 6 more vials, 7. I'm driving home. I drop him off, and I'm driving down 22 after I smoked all night. The sun's coming up. And I get this pain in my stomach, right? So I pull over, I walk into the hotel on 22, and I fall on the floor. They call me an ambulance, right? They take me to the hospital because I had like a kidney stone, so I didn't thought I was dying. And they shoot me with like
crack rock in your kidney.
They gave me like morphine and Demerol or something, right? I wake up, right? I leave the hospital and I go back to New York.
I'm not lying. Right back to it.
And then I said, you know what? Maybe I should go to rehab.
What was wrong with your stomach?
A kidney stone. So, you know, I mean, stories like that where you just keep going and don't stop.
Yeah.
You know.
He's whacking off the doctor to get the drugs. He's like, no, dude, I would give this to you anyway. It's just good. Yeah, this
what
is,
do I owe you?
No, dude, it's part of it. We give morphine.
Yeah, that's what we do here at the hospital.
You don't got...
You're not going to burn my mom's car, are you?
No, dude, really. It's aspirin. It's good.
And I worked in Boston. I met a girl at there was a club in Worcester called Plums.
Worcester.
Right? Yeah, Worcester, Mass, or whatever. It's just
that's what your grammar is compared to everyone else.
Right?
You make me sound like an English major. I love when you come in.
What's the problem? It's just a word.
Wow, Worcester.
Oh, that's great.
What's it called?
Worcester.
Worcester.
Worcester. Oh, wow.
Then I drove to Boston.
Oh, my
Worcester.
God.
Worcester.
I love him.
How do you not love him?
Just say New England. We'll know what you're talking about.
Met some girl, waitress.
Yeah.
I said, I'm not going to get high tonight. I'm going to save my money. I meet her up there. I drive. This is no lie. I drive all. I go. She goes, do you do coke? I go, yeah. She was a hot waitress. Pick her up. I go. Can you cop? And she couldn't find anywhere in Boston. I go, I know a spot. I drive down to New York from Boston.
Oh, no.
I'm not lying. I pull in. We get all kinds of crack and coke. We get one of those hotels on, you know, in Jersey on like 1 and 9. It's like flea stricken. Right? I'm banging her and doing coke and this and that. Then I'm driving her back. You know, we're trying to get heroin and stuff just to calm the nerves.
Right.
Shoot it. Just to snort it. Just
what
not to shoot
mess.
It.
Yeah. You've right? never told these stories on the air. This is amazing.
Taco Bell was closed.
Yeah. As we're driving, my nose just started, blood started gushing down my face.
How are you alive?
Yeah, just 6 hours of driving on a coke binge from
after the night before. We're trying to come down, and she's crying because she's gonna be late for work, and my face is bloody, and I'm all over my clothes. And then she goes that her and her sister wanted to get an ounce of coke, and they were gonna give me a couple grand, and I was just gonna rob her and rip her off, you know?
Of course.
And I didn't do it. And then, like, 5 years later, I was performing in Florida, and she was there with a big guy, boyfriend at
the
time.
Would have kicked your ass.
They would kill me. If, you know, what I would have thought that I, you know, I used to go on the road all the time and tell people, you know, give me a gram on credit, and I'll pay you, you know, Sunday night after the gig. But, you know, I'm already out of
You're
town.
You're gone.
I'm done.
How many people Saturday's fronted
the
you?
The last show Saturday?
Yeah, if I'm not there on Sunday, the last show's Saturday, stupid. If you withdraw, then you would know that. Here's the thing.
Well, no, I do Sunday shows. I don't have to bail out Saturday. We have Thursday through Sunday.
You're right.
Sorry, stupid.
But the money I make, I only have to do Friday and Saturday.
No, my question was, did you leave after the show Sunday, or would you bail out Saturday? I wasn't.
No, I would get Saturday night after the show.
Okay, so now instead of ripping off coke dealers, you're ripping off customers. $10. Listen to it on the way home.
That's amazing stuff, man. It's amazing.
You were really a crackhead, man.
Well, I was a drug addict.
How did you you bought from the real dregs, though? Did you go into the brother neighborhoods?
I used to go up to 168th and Amsterdam. I had keys to the front doors of the buildings. They gave me keys. And one night we were going to, me and a comic, this comic used to get high. Frank, you didn't know Frank.
Frank
you know Frank Bastille? Did you know who's a heroin addict?
How did they not just rob you?
Well, we went up one night and we were running out of money. So we hooked up with this Puerto Rican guy. And he said, well, look, I got a shotgun. Why don't we kick a door open and just rob him? We said, yeah, that sounds good.
Hey, there you go.
But I'm telling you, he goes to get his shotgun and we're driving to go. And I said, you know what? We can't do this because they have lookouts now. I go, this is crazy. They'll kill us. So we blew that idea out.
Wow.
Good.
I could tell you.
Pussy.
But wait, the story when you had the gallstone and you're passing the crack pipe.
Yeah.
Is that when you went, you know what, I'm done? This, it's over for me.
Yeah,
that was the day. And then the next day, you didn't do anything else?
I had maybe another week, but that was, you know.
And then you went someplace, somewhere.
I called
this
guy that books rooms. I said, look, I'm going to rehab tomorrow. Give me a gig tonight. And he gave me a gig. It was $60. I did the gig. Bought six vials. I smoked them till the morning. Right, until the sun came up. My mother drove me to rehab, and I never got high since.
I just want to see those little stiff fingers trying to work a shotgun as five Jamaicans are running at you with butcher knives.
These aren't lies. These are true stories. When David Spade started comedy, he came up from Arizona. He was in New York. He was just this timid little guy, did props. So we were doing a one-nighter in Jersey, me, Frankie, and him. And he was just this little white kid from Arizona, little blind. You know, if Opie was 12, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just a little.
Yeah, same hot. Little,
you know. So we do the gig. We're driving back. And we're driving back, you know, to drop him off in New York. And me and Frankie, we go, well, look, we got to make a stop first. So I take him to 160th, right?
You
go cop
scumbag.
Crack. I'm getting out of the car. It's the truth. Someone's chasing another guy with a knife. And he's scared. He goes, the guy's got a knife. I go, he's not after me. What do I care? And get out. Then Frankie, we take him down to the East Village where Frankie cops heroin.
Now Frankie's in the back. Quick cash.
Frankie's in the back seat.
Look at that ass.
I'm driving him back, and Frankie's, you know, shooting up.
What a great first experience.
He's dead, right, Frankie?
Arizona.
Yeah, Frankie's dead.
Yeah, I don't know.
His father died. Frankie was such a screw-up. His father died. Then 2 days later, he died. So they didn't know what to do with him, so they, they cremated him, and they just threw him in his father's casket under the pillow.
Are you serious?
No.
Yeah.
Holy ass.
What did he die of?
The guy was doing heroin forever.
Did he OD?
Oh.
I think he had a heart attack.
When did he die?
When he stopped breathing.
No, what year?
Oh.
He did not just say that. Funny.
Yeah, what year?
It's only word.
I don't know if he was trying to be dumped under the pillow.
Yeah, his father didn't know what to do with him because they didn't want to have two funerals, so they just put him under the pillow in his father's coffin.
Oh. That's how you know your family is sick of your drug use. Now just throw him under the fucking pillow.
Put him under there and plant him with dad. Who cares? Wow.
Well, I hope I didn't bring everybody down with those.
No, that's
a good story.
Very interesting.
So it makes you never want to do drugs before or kind of go, you know what? My weekend's boring. I might have to ramp it up a little.
How did you do, like, six vials though? It's after like the first hit it's pretty much over for the night.
Yeah, well,
you're never.
Yeah, can I ask that dumb question? I've never obviously done that. When you do one rock, like how long are you high for? You mean you smoke
it's
one
for minutes? It's not really a high. It's a rush. It's like a rush.
Oh, so it doesn't last that long at all.
And then the rest
it's
of the
like
night is
doing
spent,
ecstasy where you're
is
just
spent trying
to
get
again.
The feeling that you got from the first rush, but it never happens. You gotta like go to sleep, wait a whole day, get some more, and do it that way. Although I never smoked crack. I never. I'm one of those guys.
Yeah.
Look, I never smoked crack.
Yeah, right.
We used
I got limits, dude.
Shit in the house. We'd have like a chemistry set up. It was it was ether and ammonia.
Oh, you did the ether.
And we put it in with the water. You put the coke in, and then you heat it up a little bit, and then you take an eyedropper all the way down to the bottom of the vial, and then you pull out the ether.
Yeah.
And you spread it out on a slate, and then you blow on it, the ether evaporates immediately, and you're left behind with this white residue. You scrape it up with a razor blade. Yeah. Look at Voss smiling. This is so good. He's smiling at me like, this shit is so good.
Look at Voss.
And
sweating.
Then you put it in the pipe.
Tell me again, but tell me slow.
You put it in the pipe on the screen, and then you give it a quick, whoosh, like with the heat so it melts on the screen, and then you give it a hit. And then you get that big rush. It's like, whoa, man, holy shit. You blow out. Oh man! Wow! Look, Voss is sweating. He's wiping his head. He's sweating,
and he has a boner.
Here's the thing. Jesus. My friend. I was on the road. You know, I was doing comedy for like 2 years, or when I was doing it. And I came home. He goes, hey, "I'll get you high. You know, we'll go out and party." So he bought an eighth of coke. Right? Okay. Let me get this exactly right. An eighth was 3.5 grams. So he said, "I'll sell a gram."
Oh boy!
He said that to get. He said, "I'll sell 2.5 grams to get my money back." It was $2.50, so, and then we'll party with a gram. So we party with a gram. We're at my friend's house. So he has the other 2.5 grams cut in half gram, five packages, five. You know,
this is math. And, I'm already lost.
I know.
Well, whatever. He
he's
five
on a
half
train
grams.
Heading north. This
is just funny. He had 5.5 grams.
Okay.
And he fell asleep, and I knew where he hit him.
Oh,
right?
You scumbag!
So, I would take a half a gram. And I would cook it with the ammonia. There was a way to cook it with ammonia. I pour the ammonia out and say, "I'm not going to do this again. Steal any more from them." Right? So time goes by. I would steal another half a gram, drive to the store, and buy ammonia again. Right? I made 4 trips to the store for 4 different bottles of ammonia going, "I have a cleaning I have a cleaning service," right?
Yeah, so, cleaning out your friend of his coke.
So I smoked all his coke. Went out, I'm downstairs at my friend's house drinking a tall glass of vodka straight, and I hear upstairs someone yell, "Fuck!" Right? I go,
oh he knows.
He woke up.
Of course.
So he walks downstairs. I sold it on credit for you.
Sold it on credit. Look, I did your favor. I sold it and didn't get the money.
Yeah.
Guys, I'm doing you a favor.
What a creep.
Yeah, right. He was doing a comedy show, and he's going to be on Sunday. I'm going to get the money.
But let me, you know, all these stories, and I don't usually tell these stories because they're worth. I'm coming up on 19 years clean. So
there
I don't
it
forget.
Is. Oh, applause. That's every time. Time. That's listen. Our boy.
No, I'm not. Here's the thing. I don't want people to think I condone drug use.
Of course not.
Of course not.
You've seen the horrors of it.
You got lucky that you made it out of there.
Yeah, I mean, it's not an easy drug, you know, to
I think you should be dead. Yep. I hate to say it, but
last time I
took some unbelievable chances.
Like in the 80s. 86, I guess, 87 was the last time I did it.
Oh.
Everyone was doing it back then.
Yeah.
We didn't know it was unsafe.
You had to do it to be cool, be a part of the in-group.
That's right.
Be part of the members only.
Have your little brown vial with the spoon on the lid. Sure.
The lesson here is that you've seen the good part of life and you've seen the worser side of it.
The worst.
Right. The worser side.
You know, I mean, you know, stories. I'm just saying, if you learn anything from these stories is... you can get my DVD at richvoss.com.
Oh,
that's right,
boy.
The inspirational DVD. If your kids are doing drugs, richvoss.com.
Better than coke. You could cut your coke on it.
Yeah, yeah. It has a hard top on it to make it a little bit easier.
It's all black, so you wouldn't lose any. You could see your whole pile.
And it comes
of
with
blows.
A rolled up dollar actually pushed into the side.
You could cut it up with the side of the actual DVD. It's a whole coke snorting kit.
That's a great idea. The dollar rolled up. What a great marketing thing.
That would be hilarious.
Yeah, right. If I was a recovering addict, I would steal that and make a lot of money.
Wow, Voss. Thanks for the radio, man.
Yeah, that was good.
Good.
I love old.
We're hanging with Voss
stories.
And John Heffron. John Heffron's going to be at Caroline's all weekend long starting tonight. through Sunday. You could call Caroline's at 212-757-4100 for tickets.
But limited shows. Right. You're not doing all shows, right, because of the festival. So
yeah, you got to just call Caroline's to find the schedule. I know tonight it's at, what, 11 o'clock?
Yeah, it's a later show.
Very funny, John.
Can I say I'm in Chicago next week?
No, you really can't.
Did I tell a story, though, about me and my friend? My friend worked at this funeral parlor, and we would sit on, like, we would smoke pot with the dead bodies, and then go, you want some? And then punch him in the head, that's and go, true. You can't have any, you're dead.
That's one of my bits.
I know. Rich. I know.
Look at they photoshopped you. Where can they find this? On opiananthony.com?
That's funny.
A whack bag? Eric, where can they find this? Cage photoshopped.
And looking at it, right, Voss just opened his mouth and drooled. Nice to see 19 years clean has helped.
He fucking drooled.
He just drooled.
What the hell's wrong with you?
I don't know. Hey, did you feel bad for attacking Dee Wallace and her son in that car?
Thank him.
Come on.
Oh, Cujo. Aha.
Oh, God.
Who is that?
That's you.
With dreadlocks.
That's you
hair.
With dreadlocks. I don't know where they got that picture. They've been using it a lot on Photoshop things.
I think that's a picture of me, you, and Chappelle, actually. We took it at the Cellar years ago, and your like eyes are half closed, and your mouth is open in a horrible pose.
Oh, really, God,
look
bad.
Look at how horrible those teeth look. They had to color it out. I never had a yellow tooth.
It's a black and white picture. Well, yeah, they did. They colored in one of your teeth.
XM202. The Opie and Anthony Show.
Can we do the ear thing?
Yeah, we'll do the ear anytime.
It smells like grape jelly and it bugs me. I don't know what is behind
you. All right, who's going to take the ear thing today?
Ben will do it.
No.
Ben, do it.
I don't like it, Ben. No.
It's grape jelly.
All right, who's going to do it? One of our...
Did Steve do it last time?
Young, tender interns.
Yeah, Steve got some second whiff from
it. Eric did it.
Eric, I did it. Have you ever done this?
Well, I don't even know what it is.
You can tell he won't get sick. You can tell...
That's why I won't care. It smells like grape jelly. It's like, what the what?
Hold on.
What is it, though?
He wears cologne.
I have enough.
And behind his ear, it smells like stupid
jelly.
Hold on.
I have enough confidence.
I don't know why.
I have enough confidence that we'll get a reaction out of him.
I don't think. It smells like jelly.
We were in a parking lot at a train station, and people were puking. We were we were laughing so hard.
He's the whole gag.
Well, we need to.
Think you had him.
Well, we got to get two people. We got to get two people to get some.
John, you want in? I've done it.
It's a little.
I've done. It's behind the ear, and it's a
it's
cologne.
One of the worst smells you'll ever smell.
It's not bad. It's a cologne mix, and it smells like grape jelly. And there's no reason for it. You're a
fucking.
Well,
you got to get
jelly-headed asshole,
Casey. You know, let's get two people in.
All right, who else? These guys are in.
I don't want any karate guys.
Yeah, those two.
Right.
Oh, we got a whole studio full of
people
that want to try this.
All right, help us out with the mics.
Give it to us together.
Wait, yeah, I'll move. Right,
Jim. Everyone, move mic. Just grab that one, John.
Let me see my hat. I hope I have this one.
Go over there. Just right. Everyone move over one. All right. Sex Bagel, help him out.
Yep.
All right.
Everyone on that mic.
Wait, we got to explain this. Yeah, so
Heffron.
So there's some kind of build-up behind Voss's
and
ear.
And it's my left jelly.
Huh?
My left ear.
Wait, is he going to do it first?
Well, let him go first.
Yeah, but the last one's always the worst.
No, I got enough, I think. But, I think. I don't know. All right, ready?
Because he could describe it much better.
I do have. No, you don't.
Oh my God!
What the fuck is wrong with you? Oh. Wait a second. Okay, so that's all you're gonna do is scratch it and then sniff it.
Yeah.
This isn't like a trick.
No, there's no trick.
I sniff you and then you kiss me when I'm not. It's not one of those.
John,
things.
You gotta do it.
You better hurry up. It's going.
No, this is what it is for face value.
John, into the microphone. Look the look on John's face. What do you think?
Get some more, he says.
What do you think?
You know what it smells like?
Yeah.
I dated a girl who was a bulimic who threw up. You know how when your body starts to rot from the inside? That's what that smells like.
I did see it.
It was revulsion that came from a human being.
Right.
Heffron was taken back. Like, all comedic instincts went away. It was like an animal.
Yeah.
That smell should not come from a living human being.
Isn't that unbelievable? Isn't that unbelievable, though, John?
That's...
We have that on film. We'll put it up.
Is that...
We'll put that up on foundrymusic.com and opiananthony.com.
Scratch and sniff on your DVD?
Ah! Wait, let me see.
He wiped it on his...
That's DVD what's case. Behind your ear?
I know.
He wiped it up on. It actually, he wiped it on his DVD.
And it actually made the DVD smell better.
now I won't get it for a couple days, like a week.
Is that, that's unbelievable, isn't it?
Get away from me.
But you don't smell like I've stood around you. You don't have that smell about you.
No, not at all.
Anthony is so schemed out. I love it.
There.
So I waited. Right there, I knew I was coming in, so I let it build up a little.
Just gotta wash your hands. Put some of that stuff.
Is that from the drugs, maybe?
Put some of that stuff on your hands.
No.
Boss, put some of that on your
What is it from, boss?
Disinfectant.
Yeah, it is. It will take it right off his hand.
Boss, what is it from?
Well, you spray it into his hand. It's from so his finger doesn't touch the top of it.
It's from what?
It's hands-free.
He'll explain.
Smell it. It's hands-free soap. Like, I'm hands-free.
Look, everyone, no one wants to get near his hands now. All right, boss, what is it again?
What is that?
Can you shoot that stuff up my nose?
Voss, get on mic. What is that?
What is what? It's hand-free soap.
No.
Hands-free soap. My hands-free soap.
No, Voss, the ear thing. What is it?
It's, I think, from when I was young, not young, in high school or something, I had a cyst. And the cyst was, you know, and then I guess it just, the...
What was in it? Shit.
Ugh.
What? Anthony enjoyed it.
Shit.
At least I didn't just wash my hands with something that does require water, stupid.
I didn't read. Oh, so what? Because I didn't read the label?
Oh, well, I'm using it too.
With a prop.
But he's tricked.
I'm like, yeah, it's a. Would they have a water? Oh, no, they're still.
Does it work?
It wasn't that bad today, though.
No, that was bad. We got some good reactions today.
Did you see his face?
Yeah, John Heffron's
face. Yeah,
because
I didn't know. Because I thought maybe it was a joke you guys played and you stick your finger in my face or something like that.
No.
And then, so then when I actually smelled that bad.
His belly button's pretty bad, too.
Not as bad as that. I have to have a load my belly button the night before and then fall asleep.
You have to have a load?
Oh.
So,
if I arc, when I got Bob's
doesn't
belly,
it usually land on your chin, the load?
No, he talked about this. It hits the back wall.
Does have a good range.
That wouldn't have been...
Go ahead. Tell us about your belly button.
No, I just want that chin line to sit there. Hurts, doesn't it?
That smells different than, like, I've, like, cut my toenails and, you know, I'm that guy, like, I'll cut it and then, or if you scoop it out, you'll sometimes smell it.
Yeah.
You know, the stuff that gets in the corners of your toes, you smell it when you're by yourself just to kind of see. But that's a different smell than that even than toe crud. You know?
If he put his hand in a bowl of maggots, they would fucking slither away. I almost said they would ride away, and I'm glad I corrected myself.
Yeah. Maggots ride.
The worst of Opie and Anthony.
Let's say hi to Krista. Hey, Krista.
Hi, how are you?
Okay, what's going on?
You make me feel so young, Krista.
What's up, Krista?
You make me feel so strong and...
Atta girl.
What's up, Krista?
What's on, Krista?
Okay. Well, basically, you guys, those comedy bits, you know, during the breaks, that's, like, awful.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah, it's really bad.
Yeah.
You know, why don't you guys play the, you know, that segment that we just had? I don't think you guys should cut it. It was actually pretty funny.
What segment?
Which one?
The one with the girls with the video games.
The girls?
Oh, yeah. The Swedish chicks.
Oh, thank you.
All right, we'll keep it in the replay. What the hell?
I think it's funny.
Is that why you're calling, though?
Well, I called to ask, you know, about the breaks, and I basically, you know, spoke with the DJs behind the scenes.
All right. Are you blind?
Yes, I am. And,
oh.
I had to find the phone number, and I couldn't find it.
How'd you find it?
I gotta go.
Why?
Why?
Is that your dog barking?
Because the bus is, because I'm gonna be late for the bus, basically.
Where are you going today?
School.
You hope.
Jesus.
Oh, that's awful.
That is awful. We like Krista.
I gotta go.
All right, Krista, thank you.
Skipping through the field and tripping over things that you can't see.
When you're seeing. You make me feel your face so I can see what you look like.
You guys are awful.
You make me feel the raised letters. Forget me not, you sightless taut. Your dog just shit on my rug.
Jesus. It's a very angry show today.
That's harsh.
Wow.
All right, let's go to Jay in Cleveland. Hey, Jay.
Yeah.
Jay.
I wonder if y'all can read Braille.
No.
We can't read Braille, no.
Damn, I had a Braille tape measure on the side of my cock I need you to read.
Oh!
It sounds like you're a little pissed off at the blind humor, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sound like a couple big old fat pussy sitting up there.
I was a little offended by it too, to tell you the truth.
I don't mind the criticism, but could you not breathe heavily into the phone, you southern fatso?
He's in Cleveland.
Wherever he is, he's got a dumb southern accent, and he's breathing heavy. I got a little. I shouldn't be able to tell how fat you are by listening to you on the phone, stupid.
I can slobber on the back of your neck, too, motherfucker, while I'm holding you down.
You sound like half southern and half golfer, sir. What are you?
Use grease.
Isn't this the dude from the prank call?
Hey, do you repossess your car?
You concrete walkers.
Hey, city folks, I don't like the shoe wearing city people.
Put the powder on that ass.
So you're blind, Jay?
Yeah.
He's not blind.
No, he's blind. You can tell.
How can you tell?
I don't know.
How can you? Because someone. Who, I don't. Yeah, you're right. You can't tell. I thought I had a reason.
How do you know you're in Cleveland if you're blind?
Good question. You could call on the phone and call the area code for Cleveland and see if,
That's true.
You could write a letter to yourself and write the zip code to Cleveland and see if you get it.
Or you could stand outside of the local baseball park in October, and if you hear no noise, you're probably in Cleveland. Or you could go to Baltimore, and if you see your team playing there, then you could realize that you're probably in Cleveland. Or you could stand outside a building that should have Black Sabbath in it, but instead they have fucking Aerosmith, and then realize you're in Cleveland. Or you could look for white people and see nothing but 5,000 black guys standing in a bus stop with baseball bats, then you know you're in Cleveland. Sir, that was called being on a roll. You have to pull. You may be blind, but are you deaf with no comedic timing either? You leukemia of comedy?
Feel the bumps on his balls and tell me what flavor they are with your tongue.
Oh, jeez. Yeah. This is what happens. This is what happens when guys. What is happening with this guy?
You got skis all over your face and you know it.
Sir, you should say waka waka after every joke, you fatso.
Waka waka.
There you go. You should have that noise coming out of your blowhole, fat boy.
Ah, you big old fat pussy.
Thanks.
Go get some exercise.
Wow, he really got you on that one, I think.
I know.
Get some exercise. And you know what? Y'all ain't got no women up there. Why? Because you sit around playing with your booties in the mirror.
Did you just say booties, grown man?
Yeah, you're playing with your booty in the mirror. Sticking bananas up your ass.
All right, thank you. We're going to give Cleveland a chance to...
Bye, Gay Blades.
You make me feel like going to Cleveland and switching your furniture around in your house.
He's not blind. I hope he is blind, though, so he can kneel down and drink out of the bidet. Take a nice sip. Why does my water have, like, corn and little, little flecks of food in it?
FM 202,
the Opie and Anthony Show.
Let's go to Krista on Long Island. Krista!
Krista!
Hey, Krista, the blind chick checking in.
You're blind.
Yes.
We remember that.
Yes, okay, well...
Wait, what's the story about Krista? I don't remember Krista.
I remember her being blind. Where are you right now?
Long Island.
How do you know?
You think you're on Long Island.
Okay, I wanted to know if Norton had
Wait. I want to know how we know you.
Yeah, we need a little...
Because I called in on the air, and I was the... basically, Norton was singing, You Sightless Twat.
Oh, is that you?
Your dog just shit on my rug.
Yeah, that was it.
You're the inspiration for that?
Yeah, I'm the inspiration for that.
Oh, my God, we're talking to someone famous.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Ooh!
My little hands just can't reach my long, misshapen, ruining the family photographs face.
and you were blind since when?
Since birth.
Since birth, so it doesn't matter to you, right?
Well, I mean, it would be cool to see and everything, but...
You don't really care, though.
Yeah, but what is seeing? Do you even know what it means?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, technically, I don't know what... Well, I want to know what Norton looks like, why he can't get a date, like a real girl to bang him.
Well, it wouldn't matter what I look like to you, because you never had sight, so just for you, everything is touch. So
well, that's true.
Picture a marshmallow with an appendix scar in the middle... a mediocre head with no chin on top, and picture two fine bowling pin calves with the penis of a four-year-old boy in between them. And then you've gotten me. That's what I would feel like if I was laying nude on a cushion and you were putting your hands all over me.
What about your boobies?
Yes, I have fine B-cups. That you could mush and massage.
I'd love to see her come up and touch your face like that scene in Mask.
Oh, God.
Then you watch her just go, watch me go pull pins out as she says she won't go to Europe with me.
A little tear as you pull the pins out of that map.
That's right. Ben Sparks decides not to go. Can't go. He's having cock reduction surgery.
Oh, God. Are you married or...
No.
You got a boyfriend?
I have a boyfriend, yes.
You have a boyfriend. Can he see?
No.
No?
Well, he has some vision.
Wow, that's going to just be a mess.
How do you guys meet? You just walk
together.
Walk down the block and yell, Marco. Oh,
yeah, how did two hook up? At a blind thing?
We actually met at a summer camp.
At the blind summer camp?
Uh-huh.
That's great.
A summer camp for the visually impaired, and that was like... ages ago, so we've been friends for years.
How old are you?
I am 20.
Oh, wow, she's only 20 years old.
Are you hot?
I don't know.
No clue.
Well, what?
People say I'm hot.
Well, how tall are you?
I'm 5'4".
How much do you weigh?
120.
They're being polite.
What?
Oh, stop.
How do you know you weigh 120?
Because I go on the scale. How else would I know? And the doctor,
hold on.
You weigh 120 pounds.
Oh, yeah.
it's got to be a talking scale, right?
I hear my screen reader say all kinds of dirty stuff.
Oh, yeah. Screen reader? Go ahead.
Yeah, okay.
Let's hear what fun they've invented for the blind.
I have to shut off XM Radio Online. I have to open up Microsoft Word.
And if I lived with her, I would put a brick on the scale. What?
Oh, that would be really funny.
Oh, that's awful.
You weigh 192 pounds.
What? Stop eating.
Can you guys hear the screen reader at all?
Try it again.
Listen.
All right, let's see. Come on. Oh, I have to, like, type some stuff and then slow it down for you guys.
Sounded like it was trying to eat your pussy.
Jesus.
Well, yeah, that's because I have it so fast. Let's see, I'm trying to type something interesting. What do you want the screen reader to say, you guys?
Well, you should do some Ben stuff. Like,
all right, hey, Ben, is that a Haitian family in your pants, or are you happy to see me?
Let's see. How do I get to say Haitian?
I don't know.
Asian. No, that's not going to
work. Can it spell AIDS?
No, I'm trying to figure out. What'd you say? Is a Haitian family in Japan?
In your pants.
In your pants.
In Japan.
What, are you deaf too?
Yeah, take it easy, Deafy. I can't believe Blindy and Deafy.
Okay, here we go. Right, here we go. Let's listen to this here.
What? That talks too fast.
Oh, okay. I got to slow it down.
Yeah.
For you guys, you're not used to riding the fast lane here.
Wow, you understand it that fast.
Okay, how's this? Real slow.
Hey, Ben, is that Asian family in your pants?
I kind of heard that.
How about, hey, Ben, nice big cock.
Hey.
You heard me.
Hey.
Oops. Okay, here we go.
Amen.
All right.
We will never grow up.
I love that they invent this technology to help visually impaired people, and it's being used for a dick joke.
How about this?
Yeah, well, you can go on pdaudio.net. There's like an awesome website about where this blind guy, he did Deck Talk, which is a synthesizer, and he did all kinds of like bits.
Really?
With the synthesizer.
Yeah, we'll check it out.
Can you say this? Can you say this? Hey, gravy leg, the Patriots suck.
Look how fast you type, too.
Mm-hmm,
Hey, gravy leg, the Patriots suck all.
Hey, gravy leg.
Can you slow it down slightly or no?
Yeah, it's already really, really slow, but I'll slow it down.
Slow for you.
And then maybe just a little more volume. A little more volume.
A little more volume. I'm very lucky. I'm actually...
Something about Ben and
his
big booties.
My mom's not
duties.
Home here, so I can do this. Let's see.
All right. How do you know?
I can slow it down to that plug.
How about, you hear that one?
Yeah. How about one more?
How about, let's see. Hey, Ben, Hey, Ben, your big duties are blocking the highway.
Hey, Ben, your big duties are blocking the highway.
We gotta make promos with this thing.
Yep. How fast can it talk? Like, you're slowing it down for us. How fast can it talk?
You want it to talk really fast?
The way you listen to it under normal circumstances.
All right, hold on a second. Well, I gotta get it to slow down somehow. I mean, to speed up again.
Listen to her go. Manic.
Oh, I can't get it to speed up because I don't have enough, like...
All right.
You know, text. It was hard to... Let's see.
Wow.
That acute hearing.
You don't understand that, do you?
Yes. I do understand.
What did it say?
It actually said I'm speeding it up to normal volume. I wrote volume instead of, like, rate. But, oh well. Just because I'm a twat.
Jesus. All right. So, what do you want to ask Jimmy today?
Well, I wanted to ask him what he looked like.
Well, we got that.
Which you got that. And I wanted to know if he's had any more run-ins with the hoes of the evening.
Yeah, I've had a few. I mean, I've been better than normal. Like, a lot of times I can hold off and just, you know, throw in a porn. But, yeah, I've had
a few. Like, you mean like Max Core or something?
Max Hardcore, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You like porno?
Well, obviously, I can't like porno.
Well, you can listen to it, I guess.
There's not really much to listen to, is there?
Are you completely, like, can't see anything blind?
Basically, yeah.
Answer, like, this is the way we should ask
it. I mean, like, I maybe can see a little light, but that's about it.
Would really? A lineup do you any good?
A what?
A lineup in a police precinct.
A line? Oh, you mean, like, to identify somebody?
Yeah.
No.
Yes.
Ah.
Blind enough.
There you go, Opie. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I could recognize voices. If the guy talked enough, I'd obviously...
Have it all figured out.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Maybe he just had that machine. Take off your pants. You won't get hurt.
All right, hold on. I'll get to say that.
I love how she types. It's amazing.
Right.
All right, here we go.
Wow. Your machine has Parkinson's.
Okay, I'll slow it down so you can understand it. Take
off your pants. You won't get hurt. Unrave your motherfucking
asshole.
Hey, can you make it go...
Hold on a sec.
Little humiliated fingers.
Ooh, all right, let's see. That's about all it's going to do.
Right.
Not too cool.
All right. That's fantastic.
Well, Krista, you're a lot of fun, man.
Thanks.
A lot of fun.
You got to come in one time.
Come into the studio?
Yeah. Just maybe if you can leave now, maybe we could see you like in early January sometime.
Oh.
You know, I think I just wish I had more than just XM radio online. You know, the accessibility department over at XM, you guys are horrible with the flash and the macromedia technology. I mean, it's hard enough to get you guys on the computer with, you know, with all this technology. I've heard something about XM working with NFB to try and make it more accessible for us visually impaired people, but knowing XM, that's probably not going to be 2000 till like 2080 when I'm dead.
Oh. Hmm. Yeah, well, we'll see.
We're working on it.
All right, Krista.
Thanks.
Thank you,
sir. You were a lot of fun. Thank you so much.
Bye, sweet kids.
Goodbye, Angel Face.
Punching out.
Should have called her Angel Eyes. That would have been kind of funny and ironic.
Ironic. Keep up your good nature.
Thank you.
All right, there she goes.
Anthony. There's some sexual reference.
You know, Jay came over, really good friend of ours and stuff, and we decide, you know, to just, you know, mellow out and watch the Survivor finale last year.
Uh-huh.
Dude, this is one of the gayest stories I'll ever tell in the air, okay?
It's already gearing up to be gay. You're in second gay gear.
It's beyond gay. I'm going to admit it. I'm not gay.
Course.
But it's going to be hard to defend the story, okay?
So I hope this doesn't go, by the way, where I sense it might be going.
What?
I just don't like this.
I'm having a feeling, too.
Oh, it's awful. It's awful. I'm definitely throwing myself in the barrel here. I meant to tell this story a long time ago. So, you know, Jay was visiting, whatever, and it was the Survivor finale, and it was a cold, rainy night.
Ooh.
And we decide, you know, to get some takeout.
some cheese and crackers.
Wait a minute.
Crack open a bottle of wine. I'm telling you. I'm telling you, it's gay crap.
You could stop right there. All right. And it's already.
All right, I guess I will.
Really gay.
Do you want to hear more or not?
Of course.
All right. We go through the supermarket to get all this stuff. We're planning just a mellow night, you know, in front of the TV to watch the Survivor finale, okay?
Two men, some wine, an Afghan.
Oh, dude, yeah. Trust me.
Cheese, crackers, no dried sausage, or did you bring that yourselves?
It's awful. Shut up. So we're going up and down the aisles, and I'm like, hey, Jay, I got a fireplace that I've never used, right? So they got the Duraflames.
Yeah,
not only do they have the Duraflame logs, by the way, after I tell the story, I will not be reading my email for 2 to 3 days, okay?
All right.
So good luck trying to abuse me. And I'm not reading any message boards, and I'm not even going to answer the phones.
Oh, okay.
So we see the pile of Duraflame logs, but right next to it are Java logs.
What is a Java log?
Java logs are like Duraflame logs, but they give the smell of coffee in your apartment when you're burning them.
Are you kidding?
And I love my coffee, so I'm like, hey, let's try the Java log.
Why not get a Duraflame and make some coffee?
Why is my coffee spilled everywhere?
Sure it's not a Java log?
She spilled my Java log.
What the hell is this? This is not what I ordered.
You bitch.
This is not even close to what I ordered.
Uh-oh. Kathy Diva.
Look at this thing.
Look at that.
Wow, it's filled up to the tippity top. Look at it. It's spilling all over the console.
Like there I don't know if it was if it's possible, but I think there's just too much liquid in here and it's now trying to escape.
Did one of the savage deli people that work in this fine city, one of those savage Middle Easterns?
No, it's a Starbucks. Dude,
it doesn't look like Starbucks.
What is this? I ordered a cappuccino.
Oh, you did?
A 2% cappuccino.
Sorry, I heard the grande skin thing.
What, did they put both in the cup?
No.
The thing is overflowing.
I over-latte'd it, I guess.
Ah.
We'll go fix that.
I don't know what this is. But thank you for the effort. I really appreciate it.
No problem.
Maybe he's got other things on his mind.
This is the new friendlier Opie.
Having sex with porn stars or something.
All right. So
how's that going? Still going?
Yeah, we kind of moved on. I'm banging other girls. She's banging hundreds of other guys.
Oh.
It's in the past.
Oh.
Maybe next month I'll have an update for you.
All right. Sorry to hear that.
No, it's all right.
I mean, for the show.
Oh, yeah. Fair enough.
I like the new friendlier Opie. If someone spills your coffee, I pardon you.
I pardon you.
Anyway, so I go, hey, Jay, let's try these Java logs. So we bring the Java logs home with
all excited of the coffee smell.
And the Survivor finale is about to begin with, it was the season with, what was his name? Rupert or whatever the hell his name was.
And
the guy with the beard.
The gay guy?
The gay guy. That's like the first season, bro.
Okay.
This is only like last year.
I watched the first season. That was about it.
All right. So I start the fire. We open up the wine. We got some takeout, some cheese and crackers. Survivor's about to start. Fire's starting to crackle. Smelling the nice smell of Java.
Dude, this is awful.
I'm telling you, I know it's awful, but you know Jay, so it's not, well, whatever. I'm not even going to try to explain because it does sound awful.
It sounds all I understand.
All right, so
it sounds awful.
Sonny robbing the bank to get Leon a sex change wasn't as gay as this.
I know. So so then, you know, it's an icy, rainy night out, you know. I'm like, Jay, I'm gonna put some sweats on and get comfortable, you know.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, I know.
It just keeps going.
So I don't have sweats. I have some flannel PJs on. I'm like, well, no one's gonna. This is the key to the story. I'm like, no one's gonna see me. It's just Jay. I've known him forever.
Yeah.
Ant's known him forever. Look how I'm like, help.
Sure.
I'm just praying that you're gonna help me out a little bit here. But
I've always been completely dressed around Jay.
Well, so have I. But I just happen to have flannel PJs on.
All right.
And the wine's flowing, and Survivor's on, and
cheese and crackers.
Cheese and crackers, and the Java log.
Java log.
And all of a sudden, Jay's like, hey. Is it getting smoky in here, or is it my imagination? I'm like, what? So I look in the distance, and you can kind of just see the smoke. Little haze up high, right?
Uh-oh.
So I'm like, oh, my God, was the flume open, closed? What the F, right? So I opened it or closed it. I don't know what I did to hopefully get this smoke out, because obviously something's not working right.
Uh-huh.
So whatever I did made it so much worse. So now the smoke is just pouring out of the fireplace into my apartment. Now it's getting pretty bad. It's getting serious.
Uh-oh.
So then I decide, oh, fuck. So I decided to try to take the door flame log and throw it out my backyard. And as I'm trying to get it out of the fireplace, the whole thing explodes, making more fire and smoke. You know?
What do you mean? It like did a crackle thing?
Yeah, it's all chemical, so it kind of just fell apart. And now it's just like, now it's flaming, all right?
So, yeah, so is the situation around your apartment.
Dude, no, wait for the punchline. So I'm like, Jay, holy crap, now we got a problem. Now the smoke is just flying out of the fireplace, dark and thick, and going right up to the ceiling. I mean, it is bad. No exaggeration. So now I open all the windows, open my back door to my outdoor part there.
I'm just hearing jokes and jokes with every word.
I
opened my back door. It just gets big, black, and thick.
Right.
You know, you're saying things that just conjure an image.
If it wasn't so early in L.A., we'd have to get Jay on the phone. Maybe we'll get him on the phone tomorrow. So I'm like, Jay, there's a fan downstairs. Go get it. So he grabs the fan. The windows are open. It's freezing out. The door's open. Now we got the fan. Now we're just blowing all this black, dark smoke out of the apartment, right?
Right.
And I'm like, oh, my God, what are we going to do? Now we're just running around trying to figure this out because I can't get the door flame out, right? So all of a sudden, I'm downstairs. I forgot, trying to find another fan or something. And all of a sudden, do, banging on the door really hard. Jay's like, from upstairs, he goes, should I get that? I'm like, yeah, I guess. I don't know who's stopping by, but yeah, grab it, right? So he opens up the door. The fire department, there you go.
Yeah. But they weren't real firemen. They were Chippendales dancers. And they threw up their helmets.
Dude. So the fire department comes barging in full gear with the oxygen on, the mask, everything. I mean, everything.
Wow. Isn't that amazing that the people actually in the apartment weren't the ones that called? It got that bad?
No, it was really bad. I'm not kidding you. Obviously, the neighbors ratted me out.
Yeah.
Turns out, I went out the front door, and there were like three or four fire trucks on my block, closed off the whole street. They thought there was just a massive fire going on because of the smoke.
Just two guys eating some cheese and crackers.
So there's three or four fire department guys, in full gear that look like they just walked off one of those stupid calendars they sell every year. You know, just big, tough, burly guys in
just
their
gear. Buff.
Shut up. And there I am in my PJs, Anthony. Couple glasses of wine on the... near the couch.
It looks real bad for you.
It looks horrendous. Because remember, going back in the story, I said that I didn't think anyone was going to see me this way.
Of course.
So you do things when you don't think. You know what I mean? You're like, yeah, whatever. Who's really going to see me? So there's three or four guys in there, and we're looking just really bad and faggy. And right next to my fireplace, there's a picture of Kurt Cobain in makeup. I'm sure that didn't help the situation, right? So all of a sudden... They're staring at the apartment. They see it's a Duraflame log, right? And Jay and I at this point are trying to look tough, like, it was a Duraflame log, but we got it under control, sir, or whatever, you know?
Yeah.
And they're like, they're on their walkie-talkies, like, God, it's just a 202 or whatever they say.
202
you know?
Is fire in a fag's apartment.
Yeah, exactly. That's what Jay said, you know?
It's gotta be.
Yeah.
Yeah, you boys have fun now.
Yeah, because they're on their walk. It's only at 202, you know, Sarge, Jesus. And they're all pissed off because they were ready to, like, you know, do some serious firefighting, you know?
Of course.
And they walk out of the apartment, and Jay and I look at each other like, holy S, how bad does this look, you know?
Did anyone recognize you?
No.
Do you understand how awful that would be and go, dude, I went to Opie's apartment
and
you had a little fire incident?
No.
And apparently he's a gay man.
No. Relax on that. But they thought they were going to see some really cool shit. And instead it was like, you know, me and PJs, a little glass of wine on the side there, and a Duraflame fire out of control.
Looks bad.
It was awful.
What did they do? Anything? Did they put the log out?
I forgot. At this point, I guess, you know, we got the log on. Because I started, like, just smashing the thing until, you know, it kind of, whatever. But... Yeah, and they were so bummed out, and they just walk out of the apartment. The last guy just slams the door shut. And I'm like, oh, God, dude, we look like the biggest fags right now.
Well, I understand the worst part wasn't even the fire. It was at the end of the night, Jay felt fat.
He's complaining the cheese and crackers go right to his thighs.
Oh, I should just rub these on my midsection. Chief.
Yeah.
Chief.
Yeah, but the best part was on...
Woo!
The best part was on the walkie-talkie. Ah, it's just a 202.
We'll be back at the firehouse in about 5 minutes. Just a couple of flamers here with a Duraflame. Nothing to worry about. Just a couple of fags. We bailed them out. We'll be back at the firehouse. Yeah, remember how when we left we slid down the pole? Yeah, they're doing the same thing here in this apartment.
202. Or whatever the code was, but we knew that code was something really awful for the guys back in the firehouse.
It was one number off from a gerbil incident.
Yeah. UConn the trucker. What's up, UConn?
What's shaking, guys?
What do you got, brother man?
Hey, I want to know when you went to the grocery store if you picked up a bag of marshmallows and a cigar.
Man, trying to recreate the old fraternity scene.
Thank you. Rich in Brooklyn, what do you have?
OPNJ.
See, you try to share on the show.
There's no sharing here. Not in this forum. They're going to rip you to pieces.
All right, now we got to get Jay on the phone. We'll get him on tomorrow.
Are you going to be mad if you call and another man answers?
Shut up.
Hi, Jay.
No, this is Bruce.
Oh, did I dial the right number? Is Jay there?
Yes, he's right here. He can't come to the phone. He's got a mouthful of cheese and crackers.
Hey, thanks for that Java log suggestion.
Yeah, we really enjoy the Java log. Jay, you want to turn over the Java log? It's kind of smoking a bit. We're just sitting, drinking a little wine, and watching Survivor. Ooh, it's getting a little smoky in here.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Yeah.
What an incident.
Scott in Tennessee, what's up?
Hey, maybe you need to get a chimney sweep to come out there and ram his big black pole down your chimney chute.
It's going to be a long day.
So you didn't get it fixed?
No, I haven't used the fireplace since. Oh. The chimney obviously has to be swept out. But Flea Man from cringehumor.net, what's up?
Hey, I just want to say that I'm a cashier at a local A&P. And now on the bag of Duraflame, it says, don't leave unattended when having wine and cheese with another man in PJ.
A little disclaimer on that thing now, huh? A Java log. Did it smell like coffee?
A little bit.
Yeah, a little bit.
Here's Opie and Anthony when they don't suck.
Good for what ails you, what?
The worst of Opie and Anthony.
All right, so what's up with the Lacey Peterson song? So what's the deal? I'm serious. Is this a real Lacey Peterson song or what?
Yeah, no parody. I just want to see what kind of drivel. Who is this person?
His name is Tony Handy. He's 50, which means he's a failed songwriter.
Right.
A failed performer. Everyone has been moved by the events as they unfold, said Tony Handy. As the story went on, I wanted to get more involved.
Great.
Of course you did.
He wants to capitalize. This is like the fans... Right after 9/11, oh my God, almost as tragic as the event itself were the songs that came out after 9/11. Every band and every bad singer decided that they were going to pull the country together in song after 9/11 and really put forth a song that could capture the emotions and what we were feeling. Ugh. All of them sucked. We actually played a bunch of them on the air and tried to figure out what cornball lines they were going to try to rhyme with another.
You just hit the nail on the head, because there was two guys that actually wrote songs. Mm. And it also says, both men previously wrote musical tributes about other tragic events. Strand, a guard at Dual Vocational Institution at Tracy, composed Song for America, a patriotic folk song, 4 days after September 11th.
4 days.
Oh. They just want to be involved, and they want people to look for them as passionate artists.
Yeah.
And you're all over 40, and you
failed
performers.
Miserably.
Failed.
Those songs, they were rhyming like, I don't know, shame and plain.
Tower and power.
Tower, but we have the power. Oh, and we were just sickened.
Yeah.
Ugh. These guys just trying to get some kind of recognition with a song about a tragedy.
So this guy decides he's penned a Lacey Peterson song. I bet it's just sappy.
Oh, yeah.
And drippy.
Well, let's take a listen.
Let's give a little.
I just want to see what he uses to word with the rhyme mouthy. She was lippy, and as a result, her and Connor got drippy.
Starts off nice.
Nice.
Shit did.
No? The lounge version?
Remembering Lacey, ooh, how her smile would make you smile. Remembering
wait.
How she our smile? No,
what?
Our smile would make you smile?
Her smile wouldn't make
her
anyone smile.
Would make you smile? Is that what he rhymed?
Apparently her... Oh, I didn't catch the same word. You're right.
I think it is.
Well, we're going to have to one play that Jim's part rules again, I think.
Here and then is. We can see what he rhymes it with. I think I heard denial.
Remembering Lacey, how her smile would make you smile.
Ugh.
Remembering Lacey, how she loved, there's no denial. Now the angels hold her gently, and little Connor's with her too.
Yeah. Oh my God. And he put little Connor in.
The only thing, the only reason he should be saying denial is if that's the river she's at the bottom of.
Oh God, no.
Ding, ding, ding.
It sucks.
It does suck.
No, let's hear the rest denial of it.
Remembering Lacey and the way that fat stomach would annoy you when you're going to fuck Amber.
Oh,
Jesus, guys.
He put little Connor in.
I know.
And she smiles and says, we're all right, and we send our love to you.
Yeah. Get your lighters out, everyone.
What rhymes with Connor besides he's a
so
little goner?
Life and happiness was pretty Lacey's life. With little Connor on the way, just made things seem so right. Still the two of them together, from the start to heaven's door. And
but
she smiles and says, we
would
love
rather
you
fuck a
to
whore
the one she's loved before.
Yeah.
The tears that fell made flowers bloom on earth in heaven too. And little Connor runs and picks them.
Even
Mama,
though he's blue.
These for you.
Put on little Connor voice.
Yeah. Can we hear the little Connor voice again?
Yeah.
Mom, these are for
these
you.
These are for you.
Oh, thank you, fetus. What is that cord coming out of your stomach?
Little bouquet of seaweed he gives her.
You guys are insane. I am convinced you guys are insane with this.
Bouquet of seaweed.
This is drivel. Oh, Mom.
Well, may flowers bloom on earth in heaven too.
Ugh.
And little Connor runs and picks them. Mama, these for you.
Mama.
Now the angels.
Why does he talk like Rod from What's Happening? Little wigger.
Tributes from
yo, moms, these is for you.
As you gaze into the heavens, look, the Lacey Connor star.
How about the Lacey Connor bully?
Shut up!
Remembering
shut up,
Lacey,
shut up,
how her smile
up,
would make
shut
you
up,
smile.
Shut the fuck up! You shut up!
Remembering
shut
Lacey,
up,
how she loved, there's no denial. Now the angels hold her gently,
turn it off.
And little Connor's with her too.
Turn it off!
And she smiles and says, we're all right. And we send our love to you. And we send our love to you.
That is awful. Wow, that is horrific.
Hey, can we get one of these guys on the phone for Monday? Is that possible?
Oh,
that we played
yeah
the song. I think we should interview one of these guys.
Yeah, we want to see what.
Can we do that?
He's all about.
That's the only one. Oh God! That isn't on the song. Great ending.
Oh, that's perfect.
Oh, that is hilarious.
Oh, the little book of oh.
One body enter, two bodies leave. Oh, is that horrible?
Yuck.
Mama, these are for you.
Oh.
That is everything that's wrong with music.
Rod Stewart shit dick.
And AIDS and Scott will kill you.
The worst of Opie and Anthony.
Do we have that story about the
which one now?
The baby's t-shirts.
Oh, I think so. Somewhere because, in this pile.
Because I was laughing at the fact that they were outraged by the one that they use as an example.
Shock and awe for baby t-shirts?
Baby t-shirts. Now, these kind of risque, kind of shocking t-shirts are available for little infants, for babies now.
Mm-hmm.
And they're kind of funny sayings.
With titles like Hot Babe, Mommy's yeah. Little Monster, Diva, Serial Killer.
10%. Cereal spelt like cereal, like, you know.
What you eat.
Cereal.
Yeah.
10% soft spot, 90% bitch.
There you go.
Yeah. Is that a shirt?
Yes, it is. I'm just well, according to me now, it is.
That's very funny.
I just chimed in with that and made it up.
That's a good one.
Thank you.
But you know, I was reading their examples, and there's an outrage because of these shirts. But yeah. The examples they give are nothing compared to some of them I've seen.
Well, here's one that they're really pissed off at: a T-shirt that says "Bitch, better have my bottle."
Oh, that must get them angry.
And Sir Craps a Lot.
Sir Craps-a-Lot.
They're among the hottest sellers.
You don't like Sir Craps-a-Lot?
No, I don't. Just to say Ben on it.
there's another baby t-shirt, Anthony.
Yeah.
That says, "My mom puts out."
Wow.
I like that.
That's got now I've never seen these.
And then the
babies.
Mom is quoted saying, "But I'll bet my husband wishes it was true."
Ha, ha, ha. And I hate the one that was tasteless, though, that one from California. That there was only the one kid that wore it, and it just said glub 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 glub.
You're so obsessed. I don't really understand why, but you're so obsessed with that trial. Oh. Thank God that trial is just about over.
What trial?
Thank God it's just about
it's
over.
It's a little.
And
it's
we
a
can
little
finally move on.
Is that the little shirt?
Yeah, it's a little shirt. And you can wash it as many times as you want, and it won't shrink because it's used to being in the water.
Right. And it's got a little arrow pointing one way and says, "I'm with mommy who wouldn't shut up." No?
Ooh.
Oh.
And another t-shirt, ooh. Anthony, that says, "Where's all the bitches at?"
Where's all the bitches at?
Now, you're saying these shirts are tame compared to the other ones that you've seen out there?
One of my favorite sites is t-shirthell.com.
Okay.
You ever go there?
No.
Very funny t-shirts. And they have a whole baby section. And these are much better than the ones they give examples for. Imagine you're a little toddler wearing a shirt that says, "Now that I'm safe, I'm pro-choice."
Oh, that's...
Now that's kind of funny. I tore mommy a new one. another one reads... Chinese delicacy. Do they cook, child?
Did you get this one, Anthony? "Now that I'm safe, I'm pro-choice."
Yes, that's the one I just read.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, because someone's distracting me.
Oh, my God, that's hysterical. I have no idea.
No wonder you can't remember who made the mess.
What? Well, you guys don't understand. During the radio show, I'm taking my headphones off, turning microphones off, giving instructions, receiving communiques.
This one's cool.
Yeah.
I tore mommy a new one.
All right. I heard that one, you ass.
You're coming off as an insane person
today. I know. But
whose Rolaids are these?
Rolaids in my studio.
Opie,
Tina,
dearest,
you know there.
Get the suntan lotion.
You know there are times during the show I'm taking my headphones off, turning microphones off, and trying to find other stuff to enhance some of these bits that we do.
Right.
So I got caught. I got caught napping on that one. I'm sorry.
How about this one? "Fuck the milk, where's the whiskey tits?"
There you go.
You're a little toddler being... Yeah, that's a real one. Funny. You could buy it.
Did you say the one... I pray you didn't. "They shake me?"
No, I didn't say that. Right. Well, how funny is that as a shirt for your little
that's
kid?
That's a little crazy.
Kid walking around with a "They shake me" t-shirt.
Yeah.
How about Daddy Drinks Because I Cry? Did you do that one?
No, okay. Didn't do that one. I enjoy a good spanking. Playground Pimp.
Daddy's Milk is Saltier Than Mommy's.
Oh, that's
that's not a t-shirt.
This one has a big pot leaf on the front, and it's a little t-shirt for your baby, and it says Potty Head. You know, a little play on pothead. Potty Head.
Did you read the one Hung Like a 5-Year-Old?
That's very funny. Daddy's Lil Squirt, and it says L-I-L. It's spelled Lil.
What about this one that just says Broken Condom?
Hmm.
Oh, those are funny shirts.
Oh, my IQ is higher than the president's.
The old I Can Kick Your Baby's Ass. Yeah. Those are a little more offensive than the examples they gave.
And I Hide My Crack in My Diaper.
Mm-hmm. There's one from... This is a weird one. If you're in Florida in 1981, don't lose your head.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Then there's ones... T-Shirt Hell is great. They have T-shirts for everybody, not just for kids.
Mm-hmm.
There are some really, really offensive ones. Arrest black babies before they become criminals. I mean, that's what it says.
Jesus. Well, I thought that was a boss post.
Who the hell would get that? This one, really offensive. You know the I Love New York shirts? I Heart New York?
Yeah.
They have I, and then in place of the heart, they have an airplane, a jet aircraft. I Plane New York.
Oof.
Yeah. People, I mean, this is it's T-shirt hell, and this is in the extreme section. But there, I would defy anyone to walk around wearing one of these. Jesus did it for the chicks. Abortions tickle.
That's funny.
Oh my God.
Great White kill is a headline on a shirt. Great White kills every single one of its 100 fans. I swear, I didn't know she was 3.
That's my favorite one.
Oh.
I didn't know she was.
If Asians were so smart, how'd they wind up with such tiny dicks? Help stop rape, consent.
That's nice.
T-shirt hell. There you go. Oh, God, I can't even read that one.
Why?
I found one I can't even read.
Really? Norton, read it.
Where is it?
It's right here.
Norton will take pleasure in reading it, I guarantee.
It's this one. No, it's not. Oh,
geez. He's laughing. You're not going to read it?
Of course I'm going to read it. I just didn't want to... Is it a ton?
Yeah.
Love him or hate him, Hitler killed a ton of Jews.
Holy ass. Are you insane?
Who's walking around with that?
Yeah. Byron.
A picture of Hitler. Right, Byron from yesterday, sure.
Be an Anthony, XM 202.
All right, here's the story of the day. Canine used to subdue naked suspect. Tuesday afternoon around 12:05, it was a man, a stark naked man, checking for unlocked doors. Completely naked, going from home to home, right?
There you go.
He found one at Craig Martinson's home. I know he scattered a bunch of lunch around. I know he was on all floors. What does that mean?
Where's that, sweetie?
Either he was on all fours and they made a mistake, or he was on all the floors of this guy's
either way,
house.
It's a mistake, though.
Like if he was in the basement or the...
All right, so the guy broke into
maybe
a home.
Everywhere he walked was a floor.
The guy broke into a home. He was stark naked, okay?
Yes.
A half dozen cops were on the naked man's trail, including an officer with a canine named Zach. The cops spotted the naked man inside this guy's home and ordered him outside. At that point, the suspect leaped toward the canine officer and punched the canine officer in the head.
Bad move.
That is not a good move.
Bad
move. These dogs are vicious. Doing what the dog is trained to do, protect the handler, the dog jumped and bit the suspect in the genitals.
Ow!
In this case, the genitals. That's correct. One neighbor says she watched as police appeared to recover part of the man's testicles from the porch area of the home.
Oh, no.
The dog bit his balls.
Right off him.
Just think, you're a dog. That dangling meat, it's a perfect target. And to rip a piece off for a dog is nothing. That's nothing. It's just hanging there.
Minneapolis police say their canine officers are never trained to attack the genitals, but suspects usually aren't naked either, Anthony. Uh-huh. As the neighbor across the street told us, who happens to council member what? Scott Pent? That doesn't make sense either. Well, whatever. This seems to be an incident without precedent. It's highly unusual. Don't have much criminal activity since I moved here 15 years ago. So, obviously, the neighbor has never seen a naked guy get his testicles bitten off by a canine dog.
Yeah.
Basically what's going on there, right? And the suspect is in serious, stable condition. Police are investigating whether the suspect was on drugs.
I like this part.
Go ahead.
Even after the canine bit the suspect right in the junk, Minneapolis police say officers still tasered the suspect several times. There you are. You're bleeding sack because it was bitten off by a dog, and you get a little taser action, too.
You're laying on the ground just hoping the dog doesn't swallow it.
Zach, the canine, has a clean record, but is off the street pending the outcome of an investigation. Why? The dog was doing his job.
Well, now they'll probably have to shoot the dog, right? That's what we do
if
in this
If I was
society.
The owner, I'd shoot him. You're not going to go home and go, give me kisses. Give me kisses, Zach. Licking you with man testicle breath.
Oof. Mike in Jersey, what's up? Mike.
Hey,
Yeah.
Hi, boys. Listen, I actually read in the paper they're getting rid of the dog.
Oh, yeah?
And, yeah, the way they're doing it is they're actually sending him to Opie's house so Opie can kick him in the liver.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. I really don't know what he's talking about.
Chester!
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Chester!
Like I said, I have no idea what you're talking
Chester,
about.
Chester, where are you, Chester?
Shut up!
Chester!
Shut up!
Chester, where are you?
Shut up!
Chester, why are you limping like that? Why is Chester Boy limping?
This never happened.
As if someone kicked him in the liver.
Shut up. We agreed we're not ready to tell that one yet. We're not
ready. It's been 10
Shut
years.
Up.
It's been 10 years. When will we be ready?
We're just not ready for that story.
Chester!
We're not ready for the Chester story.
Chester Boy! If I didn't know any better, Chester, I would swear somebody kicked you in the liver.
You know what? I'm going to save myself here.
Chester has...
This will be the cliffhanger.
Chester
this
has
will be the
tumor.
Cliffhanger. Shut up.
Chester has liver cancer. The vet is saying it was caused by something.
No, that's not true.
I believe it could have been a kick to the liver, no, but who in my house would kick my beautiful Chester in the liver? Who?
It's going to be the cliffhanger.
There are only a limited number of people that come into my apartment. I could count them on one hand. And I know none of them are mean enough to have kicked little Chester in the liver.
You don't know what happened.
I wasn't there.
Exactly.
I don't know what happened. But based on...
Shut up! We agree. Shut up.
Oh, Chester! Where are you, Chester? Chester looks a little run down these days.
Shut up.
Chester's not as perky as he used
this
to be.
This will be the cliffhanger. Maybe we'll finally tell the Chester story on Monday.
As I remember from just yesterday. Is something bothering you, Chester? Chester, why do you have a Nike print on your side?
Shut up! You just saved me because I've never worn Nikes.
Oh, I made a mistake. That's not a Nike logo. I believe it's a Puma logo on your side. Actually, this is so odd. If I didn't know any better, I could swear that those are rollerblade prints on your side. I know one person that rollerblades.
No.
Who do I know that rollerblades? Chester. Chester's having problems coming up the stairs.
Dude, he's making all this up, Ben. Don't look at me differently.
I wonder if this has anything to do with broken stuff around my house.
Shut up!
All the broken items that have just been sitting here for years and years and years.
It's my mother-in-law's, my ex-mother-in-law's dog, Chester. My mother-in-law. Opie lived with my mother-in-law for a while.
Oh, just for a little while. Not
a little
long.
While.
Not too long, no.
When we moved to Massachusetts.
I was there
to do our show at AAF.
A mere couple of years.
I know. I moved in. It was me and my ex-wife living with my mother-in-law.
I am so happy to have you kids living with me here in Ashland. This is wonderful. And Opie's moving in also.
And I was like, in a second, we got to get out of here. Get an apartment. I don't care. We got to get out. Opie wound up living there forever.
Yeah.
You were there for so long, like months and months and months.
No,
like
I
about a year.
Yeah, it was about a year.
I lived with my mother-in-law for a year.
Do you still keep in touch with her?
No. Why would I? It's my ex-mother-in-law.
You might have developed a friendship.
No. No. Nice enough woman, but why am I going to, you know, keep in touch with her? You know? She gets to see... I send her daughter pictures of Benjamin Franklin. Lots of them. Every 3 months. So I don't think... I think that's as close of a relationship as we have. But Opie stayed there, and El Klutzo was constantly breaking stuff. She had little knickknacks and trinkets all over the place. And
dude.
Opie would be on the phone,
she was
and
the
phone cord is swinging,
hitting
Hummels.
She was the last
Hummels.
Person in America that had a cord on her phone.
I know.
And it was like 50 to 60 feet long,
it was
remember?
So long, so Opie would go out of the kitchen.
No exaggeration, this cord was 50 to 60 feet, and I like to pace when I'm on the phone.
Yeah, and it looked like a big tangled slinky when it was when the phone was hung up, because it was stretched out and so so tangled. So Opie would be pulling this thing, and it's trailing this ball of... coiled up phone wire that's swinging just like a wrecking ball.
It was like almost like a tail, like a dog's tail.
Why are my Christmas Hummels all broken? I've had these for years and years and years. I take perfect care of them. I don't understand. I know Chester doesn't jump up where he would break them. Why is Chester limping? Why?
Dude.
Chester was fine
I have no
yesterday.
Idea, right?
And now Chester...
I really have no idea. Stop.
That's what Chester would do all the time.
Maybe if the dog didn't eat my prime rib dinner.
The devil.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, it's devilish.
What? What happened?
Power of Christ compels you. The power of Christ compels you. Must get this, cast this demon out.
Anyway. That's a story for another time, Anthony.
I think I have to find out right now what happened to my little boy, Chester. He's since passed away, and his ashes are in an urn in my living room. But I don't understand. He seemed fine. And then all of a sudden, out of the clear blue, he all of a sudden developed a limp, and he couldn't get up the stairs. And Anthony had to come over and carry Chester up the fucking stairs every day.
Dude, thanks.
The dog was old. Real old.
The dog was old.
It was real old.
And because he was old, I'm sure he didn't need any
No, the dog was
shocks.
Arthritic, obviously. He
needed no sudden shocks to his little old body. Like maybe a fall, because he's old.
What
Perhaps
I,
if something was
What did I do to you today?
Him. Or perhaps
what did
know,
I do
he
to
doesn't
you
need
today?
To be hit by a car, or walk out and have the paperboy throw something and hit him, or perhaps being kicked in the side. All right.
What kind of dog was Chester?
A lovable mutt. Aww. Just a lovable mutt. I had him since he was a little puppy. Now he's gone. My Chester.
Opie and Anthony. No more of that. It's bad for you.
Finally, the last one that came in today.
Oh.
What would you do for a MiFi? Went off on a little tangent
still
there.
Still on that.
And if you want to come up with something, you could get to opieandanthony.com and email us, right? It's up on that one? All right.
Go to a movie in the Bronx? No?
This is probably, we've heard some sick ones today, but I think this is the sickest. I think this is the sickest one. What happened?
He tried to get Ben. Anytime you hear Jim go like, real low in the mic, that's him trying to get people.
Yeah, this one involves Master Poe.
Oh, it does.
Yes, it does. I would get into an octagon with Master Poe.
What's an octagon, by the way?
Not the octagon.
The octagon ring.
Oh,
eight-sided ring, right?
Okay.
Poe?
Yes.
Usually an octagon has eight sides. Yes.
Okay.
Right? Yes. Okay. With Master Poe for 3 to 5 minutes. UFC rules. Well, 3 to 5 minutes if Poe can last that long.
Ultimate fighting champion?
Yeah. This guy's getting really cocky, saying if Poe can last that long. If I make it through the time without tapping or getting KO'd, I win the MiFi. If I knock him out or submit him, I'll not only win the MiFi, but I'm known as the Poe Killer, and I get to call and taunt him on his loss at least once a month. If he beats me, I'll walk around wearing a I'm Master Poe's bitch t-shirt wherever I am directed to.
Wow. That sounds like a challenge. That's like when little Danny from The Karate Kid went up against Cobra Kai. All the guys from Cobra Kai. And you know what he did? He kicked their ass, Opie. Mm. If I may remind people of the plot of The Karate Kid.
Well, let's get this guy on the phone. I want to talk to him, see what he's about.
That's right.
So it sounds like a tough guy.
He's very cocky, so we'll get him on after the break, eh?
Don't make me come down there to get you, too, tough guy. I stink. The line.
All right, we're going to break. We're going to break.
Guy from Boston threw me.
Yeah.
Totally used me up. I'm old Phil from Boston. I'm his used condom in the toilet.
Are we on break?
Yeah. Why, you got something to tell us?
Are we on break?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are we on break? Are you sure we're on break?
Why?
I'm asking you, are we on break?
Yeah, we're on break. We're just sitting here waiting for them to tell us to come back on the radio.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why are you guys putting me into this?
Putting this you into what?
This is not good. You're going to have some idiot coming down here.
Right.
And I'm going to have a lawsuit on my hands. This is bad.
You think he'll kick his ass?
I don't even know the guy.
What if he's like,
It doesn't matter.
It might be Ortiz or somebody.
That's wonderful.
Hoist Gracie.
That's wonderful.
Hoist Gracie, right.
Could probably afford a...
How much time before we break? From break? 2 minutes? Three? Oh, 2 minutes, all right.
2 minutes.
I had a whiz.
Do you brawl people you don't know?
I fought before. Yeah. I'm not here for that. I'm here to protect you guys. You got it?
Yeah, why are you protecting us?
I don't know. Supposedly you had some people that didn't like you in the past.
Yeah, a couple, but we can take care of them.
That's good. I'm glad.
Yeah, because you don't even know it, but Ant and I carry.
That's good.
Yep.
Glock?
Just a little.
Nine?
A little something something.
American Express, and yeah. I have a MasterCard. About all I carry.
AIDS.
Carry AIDS.
Get back or I'll bite you.
Well, I got to take a leak. Well, we'll talk to the guy when we get back from break, and we'll see what he's about, all right?
All right.
Cool.
I got to take a leak.
Yeah.
I want to hear this Richard Cheese thing, Baby Got Back. Richard Cheese is going to perform on our show, I think.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Is he?
He's now listening and realizing he was on the radio, and now it's going to get ugly. And he's coming back. He's like, here he's... He's pissed.
Oh, boy.
I'm not even leaving the studio.
You have to go in the bathroom. He's going to kick your ass all over that bathroom.
I'm not leaving the studio. He's coming back in.
Oh, man, is he
you
pissed.
You fucking God. I've been through a 5-year litigation. You think I want to get on the fucking air with this asshole? Now I'm pissed.
Master
hey,
Poe,
guys!
It was Anthony's...
Radio's radio.
Hey, I didn't say anything.
I went through a 5-year litigation.
It was Anthony's fault.
Look,
it was Anthony's fault.
Hey, what are you pointing at me? I didn't do shit.
Jim, it was five years.
It was Anthony's fault, right?
5 years. They took everything.
I can't believe Anthony
now
would do that to you.
Now I'm going to get some bendejo on the phone that's going to say that he wants to challenge me.
What?
Whose idea was it to make believe we were off the air? Anthony's, right?
What are you talking about?
Rewind the tape. Opie's long gone. No,
that is stupid.
Yeah, that was really stupid,
Anthony. When Master Poe asked, are we off the air, who's the one that said, yes, we're off the air?
That was you.
Bullshit. It was Opie.
Jim?
Guys. Who was the one that said, hey, how long until we're back on the air? 2-3 minutes?
That is not why I'm here.
Clever ruse, Opie.
That is not why I'm here.
Right.
Okay? My skills does here. Not pertain to
get on
to
the
sport.
Mic because we're on the radio now.
Oh, we are?
Yeah.
This is fun.
Oh, boy. Oh,
hello?
Oh, my God.
No. We're on the air. You're talking to us.
Okay, yeah. Okay, now, what?
No, the guy
you guys
ain't on
pissed
the air.
Me off, man. I'm telling you.
I know, Anthony.
5 years of litigation. The worst combat in my life.
Oh, boy.
The worst.
What happened?
You can't just reach over.
Are you allowed to tell what
first
happened?
First insurance. Punch the judge. Wow, no, first a flood. All right, wait, hold on.
But what happened?
No, I'll tell you. 1999, I was hit with Hurricane Floyd. 3 years of litigation with that.
Yeah, and that has nothing to do with fighting somebody.
Oh, wait a second. We're talking about litigation. We're talking about legalities here.
Is he trying to say he tried to fight a hurricane?
Is he smiling?
No, yeah. I'm not.
No, it's not a smile. It's more of a growl.
Okay. And then...
All right, Hurricane
and
Floyd.
And then after that, and then my divorce.
Stop
come
whining.
On. Any man that's out there...
Stop whining.
Okay.
Look, my hands are above the table. Look.
Guys...
I don't push those buttons.
Guys...
I don't push those buttons.
You brought me into this.
Look, I'm going to explain.
And that is not why I'm here. I'm not here
I handle
to
the
entertain.
Phone calls. Anthony does the sound bites, right, Anthony?
I'm not doing anything.
Well, technically, the guy did. You really didn't do anything because the guy just called and asked for it.
Yeah, that's
no.
All.
You said no.
Yeah, you actually said no.
I didn't say anything. I didn't even talk to the guy.
But you fought a hurricane and you got divorced. That has nothing to do with beating up somebody for the radio show.
Litigation.
But this guy's saying he could kick your ass.
Well,
and I had enough confidence to say that Master Poe could kick this guy's ass.
That's not why I'm here. You want to put him on the phone? You want to put him on the radio?
We're gonna no, not if the fine. Litigation thing. What's with the litigation?
Yeah, what's with the litigation?
5 years of going through court.
Yeah.
Dealing with... Oh. Is that it? You're setting me up.
Wait a minute. I have nothing to do with that.
Opie. I have nothing to do with that.
This is going to be fun. Somebody's going to attack.
Insane?
Somebody's going to attack, and I'm going to duck, and it's going to hit you in the eye.
Pow!
Are you insane,
pow!
Anthony?
I'm not doing anything.
Let Master Poe tell his little story.
No, I'm not going to say nothing.
Holy crap.
You got me pissed off.
All right.
I don't get angry.
What's up with the litigation?
Nothing.
Huh?
You're going to hit the laughter button.
I don't have laughter buttons.
Don't lie.
I don't have laughter buttons.
I love how me and Opie will just throw each other under the bus
about?
At a moment's notice.
I am. We got to play something going into the real break. That's all I'm doing. That's all I get to play here is music. Trust me.
Well, we're not on break. We're on the air.
Yeah. Right. Well,
yes,
I'm getting
I know
ready.
We're on the air.
I'm getting ready to play something into break. That's
uh-huh.
All. Go ahead. Now, what about the litigation?
I just told you.
Did you fight somebody?
Oh yeah.
All right. And what
the
happened?
Worst combat of my life.
In what way?
Divorce.
Oh, that.
Oh. Oh, you see? Now we
lost
are
everything.
We are brothers at combat.
What do you mean you lost everything?
I lost everything. I lost my home. I lost my business. I lost my cars. I mean, what else? Oh, more laughter.
Oh, my God.
This is great. I'm getting excited.
Anthony.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, Opie.
Is
you
he looking
are...
at us?
Oh,
I don't know. All I know is there's no way I'm getting my teeth kicked in because there's no buttons in front of me.
He's not looking at us, right?
Mm.
All right. So what happened?
Nothing.
Nothing. Oh, Jesus Christ. We're in trouble.
Not a thing.
All right. I'm going to...
why don't we go into a break? Because I have to tinkle.
Could someone open that door? I think I can make it.
Mm.
Oh, you think you can make it past them?
I think so.
I think you'd be clotheslined in a second.
You want to have a push-up contest?
Sure.
All right. So it was a bad divorce?
Is that your phone thing ringing?
What's that noise?
No, I don't know what that
in
is.
In my headphone?
It's not mine, though. All right.
Yeah.
Look, I have nothing. Look, my hands are up in the air.
That's nice.
You know it's Norton,
good
right?
Place for it.
You know it's Norton?
He cues things with his feet.
Mm. It's just a matter of time before it becomes the Master Poe show. You know that, right?
Oh, geez.
He could take over this place anytime
yeah.
he wants.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, this is what I'm doing. I'm going to play some Richard Cheese. He's a really good friend of ours, and he's coming in soon. I'm actually shaking.
Richard Cheese?
Yeah. So are you better now from the divorce, now that it's over?
I want you to know that I don't curse.
I'm just asking.
I haven't cursed in years.
No, you cursed when you came in here. We're just getting to know each other.
I said I haven't cursed in years.
We're just getting to know each other.
He can tell you that.
You lack discipline.
I had nothing to do with that.
Mm.
And that didn't make sense anyway.
Yeah.
Yes, it did.
There's plenty of discipline.
Yeah.
It completely made sense that you did that.
I didn't do that one.
I mean... You know, Stephen King came out with 50 quotes.
He did.
50 of his all-time favorite movie quotes.
Oh. Well, we're going to take a break.
All right.
We're going to go through a couple of those.
Poe, is there anything else you want to say?
No, because you're going to say we're taking a break and we're not taking anything.
Oh, no, we're going to take a break.
Oh, that old clever ruse of Opie's?
Uh-huh.
Mm. I agree with you. That was underhanded.
Jerry, do you know the human head weighs 8 pounds? That was Jonathan Lipnick in Jerry Maguire.
Oh,
yeah.
That's kind of funny, right?
Number 49. No, not necessarily the funniest, but the best movie quotes.
How about you get something that's funny?
Lipnicky?
Something that's funny?
Yeah. Let's go to Chris on the phones. Chris, what's up?
Hey, guys. Love you, Jim.
Hi, Chris.
The contest is over. Opie just won the MiFi. Too bad he's not going to live long enough to use it.
That's funny.
Watch it out, guys.
Hold on. You don't really think it was all me, right?
No, nobody thinks.
No, not you. I'm talking to the guy that looks like he wants to kill me. It wasn't all me, right?
We're going to find out if a MiFi works up the human rectum. It'd be an interesting little experiment.
So.
I'm not bad. I'm just drawn that way. That was Jessica Rabbit in Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Oh, what number did that come
number
in?
Number 40, Ant.
Number 40.
Let's say hi to Jeff in Arkansas. Jeff?
Come on, Marshmallow Man. Run past him. Go ahead.
I'm sizing up the room. Trust me.
Fag.
There's only one way out. That's the problem.
Marshmallow Man.
Why don't you put Steve's boots on?
Oh, you could run faster if your boots are on fire.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye. Hey, what's going on?
Steve C. and clothes by Pass Hibachi.
What?
Pass me the garbage can.
Why?
Who are you going to hit with it?
He's going to put them in a garbage can.
Now I'm going to protect myself. Oh, all right. You want me to try to get over the counter?
Opie was just
no,
so
that's your
fearful
for now.
Right there.
No kidding, dude.
You were just like, uh-oh, what am I going to have to do?
Joey, do you like movies about gladiators?
Oh, Airplane.
Airplane.
That was Peter Graves. That was number 31.
31? What are you doing every 10?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just skipping around. Just waiting to see which one of you two is assaulted first. I have nipples, Greg. Could you milk me?
That would be Meet the Parents.
Yeah.
The nipples, they feel like kind of tingling. Ooh. My nipples are very sensitive.
Hmm. What was that from?
I believe it was the one where Arnold was pregnant.
Oh, she's daddy's little girl. That's funny.
It's not a tumor.
It's just a lump on the side of my head.
Junior, that was the movie. Junior. Yes, I'm in the movie Junior. Junior.
So, how are we going to solve this, Master Poe?
Jenny.
Huh? You know Anthony had a lot to do with it, right?
No!
You know Anthony's the instigator on this radio show.
Why is
He's the puppet master.
Mm. The puppet master. Yeah, I'm quite a puppet master.
Well, when's Tom Cheese coming in?
Richard Cheese?
Yeah.
Richard Cheese.
Oh, yeah, Tommy Cheese is a comedian on New Year's
Eve. Richard Cheese is coming in soon.
You know a comic named
Tommy Cheese, yeah.
He has a new CD out called Toxicity. And we're going to play Baby Got Back, his version. Why is he walking around the counter? What are you going to do to me?
I think you really...
You?
That's right.
I think you owe Master Poe an apology.
I think so.
For your little, you know,
what
off
about
the
you?
Air. I didn't do the off the air bit.
See, guys, I'm not here for sport.
Yeah.
I'm here in case someone wants to kill you.
But
not wants to submit you.
Well, no, it sucks.
If they want to come in with a knife and take it and thrust it into your stomach,
uh-oh.
That is my prevention. I am your buffer. I'm the protector.
But right.
I'm your god, I'm your king, I'm the one that will protect you and take one if I have to.
But now the protector wants to kill us. How stupid are we?
Doesn't that always happen? the Roman army comes back and...
He's our bodyguard. He's our Kevin Costner, and I'm certainly Whitney Houston in this situation.
I would have said you're Adam Baldwin. I thought he was a more effective bodyguard, if you remember the original film.
Hmm.
Not Alec, Adam.
Adam, okay.
I was thinking Linderman.
That's what I meant, Adam Baldwin. That was his real name.
Was it?
Adam Baldwin, yes, and Opie is Chris Makepeace.
Well, I guess...
and that friend with the awful sinuses, Linderman.
Well, I guess we learned a lesson here today.
Matt Dillon in that?
Yes, and maybe and that would be Steve can be Moody.
Moody.
And Ben can be the Ruth Gordon character, the grandmother. You're among friends, Ricky. His little slash wrists. Come on, Hobson.
Wow, you have seen that a few times.
My father took me to see that in the movie theater.
Oh.
He took me to a Woody Allen film, and I went to punch him in the balls because I was too young to get it.
So, still trying to take a break, but I don't know how we do this.
I don't know. You put the thing in, and we all go pee.
There you go.
Am I allowed to go pee?
I don't know. Can you?
Another 10 minutes, I'm going to pee in my pants.
Ooh. Who is your daddy, and what does he do?
Let's see how long you could last.
Oh, boy.
All right.
Oh, boy.
Tim... in D.C. Tim, what's up?
Hey, how's it going?
Good, what's up?
Hey, pose is fake.
What do you mean pose is fake?
Why is that?
Why is that? Because whenever you first mentioned putting him in a ring with somebody, he comes up with this BS litigation, and then he comes up as though he actually kicked somebody's ass. excuse me. And then he comes up with this BS as though he was in 5 years of litigation, had nothing to do with actually fighting. The guy, I guarantee he's not proven in any ring. And he's an actor.
Pretty strong words from D.C.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to shit-talk from Virginia.
Well, let's ask...
Or Maryland, actually.
Well, why don't you say that to Poe? Or Poe, what do you think of that?
Anyone that gets in the ring, it's for sport. What is your name again?
Opie just ran.
What is your name?
Tim.
Hey, Tim, how you doing?
I'm doing all right.
So what you're saying is that because I don't get in the ring and...
No, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, why did you make up the story about being in litigation and make it appear as
Tim, I don't think he made anything up.
Yeah, I don't think
you're
so.
You're just trying to stir things up, aren't you?
Yes.
Yes, you are.
Jesus, Tim, you could have...
It's an observation of truth. It's not masked behind some... I'm a badass bodyguard.
Oh, hang up on him. I've had it. I don't like him stirring things up while we're sitting in here in the cage.
I don't like him kicking the hornet's nest while we're sitting in it.
Exactly. A lot of people wondering if Opie is sitting down to pee right now as he's in the bathroom. All right, we'll take our little break, and then we'll be back after Opie urinates.
Opie and Anthony, XM202.
And we're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. I'm still shaking. No joke. Now I got to smooth things over with our protector. The instant feedback went nuts, Anthony. Hey, Opie, distract him with the flying poker chips. Lots of balls now, huh? He will break you like you did to Stalker Patty's frame. Al from whackbag.com, you need to hire somebody to protect you from your protection.
Yes.
Let's see. Yeah, Opie, you're gonna pee, but you're gonna have to sit down and do it. Let's see. Poe's gonna reach through the phone and choke this genius. Jason from Delaware. Will XM be able to figure out how to live broadcast from two funerals? Angel from Jersey. Master Poe, relax, dude. Master Poe, if ONA and Jimmy love you, they will include you in the show. It's the nature of the show. Just chill out. Don't kill them, please. I've waited 2 effing years for my dudes to get back on the air. It just goes on and on, Anthony.
I'm not afraid because I, Opie, am a level 18 sorcerer on EverQuest 2.
So you know how to handle this situation?
I could stun him with my freeze spell.
Yeah.
And make quick my getaway.
Yeah, that'll work.
Maybe I could use the shackles on him and freeze him in place as I run for the zone line.
Sure. Patrick from Brooklyn. When I went down to the studio, Poe scared the shit out of me and my friends, and Old Dirty was mentally altered by Poe. He's the real deal.
Well, you know what else you can do? Like what a lot of EverQuest guys do in this real controversy? The old trick of kneeling and taking the zipper down with the teeth and going, whoa, 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 whoa.
I haven't seen that in my offense book or anything. My spell book doesn't have, holla, holla, holla.
You throw a flaming mouth at the man's genitals.
Oh, look, it's hitting for a lot of damage.
Henchman,
my dignity level is going down.
Henchman from Brooklyn. Hey, guys, I heard music soothes the savage beast. Maybe a little more Richard Cheese will help the situation. Mm. You know, I think we should clear the phone lines. I don't need to get in any more trouble.
You notice how quiet Steve was during that little thing? He didn't. His little Lebanese temper didn't flare at all.
Oh, yeah.
And Johnny Baby from Canada, did you read that one?
No.
5 years of litigation, worst fight of my life, nothing works here, I hate this place. Shut up.
It's really tough to do a show when you got adrenaline flowing through your body.
Oh.
How long does it take to calm down? About 20 minutes, maybe?
You're really like...
Oh, dude, man. You see, look at my hand. You see the look he was giving us?
Yeah, I know, but he's a paid employee. I think he knows his boundaries and, you know, what his job is. You know, there are some times we come in here and perhaps we've had a disagreement with somebody else in the office. We don't go to throwing fisticuffs, Opie. We deal with it. Maybe a little time passes and everything's fine. Poe's a professional, well-disciplined. Professional.
I hope he's listening to all this.
Here's what you're missing, though. You guys deal with it the way you deal with it, which is on the air and well. So when there's a problem in the office, you deal with it on the air. The way he deals with problems is he removes a limb.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
His way of dealing with it may just be his natural thing of pulling off a freckled blonde arm and beating Opie to death with it. He would probably beat Ben so hard, Ben's hair would just straighten out, look nice and neatly combed.
Impossible.
He'd hit Steve so hard, his little boots would ice up.
Hat would go out. All of a sudden, you just see smoke. Yeah.
I noticed Steve was awfully quiet during that
That's
whole
what
thing.
I'm saying. He didn't say anything.
It's amazing.
Oh, I know. Yeah,
I don't want him to throw water on my boots.
Actually, Steve, for many years, Steve was our defender.
He was our protection.
Steve was our protection. Yeah. Did you see how quickly Steve handed Poe the garbage can without knowing what Poe was going to do with it?
Here's the trash can.
Steve just handed a weapon over to him.
I thought I was going to be completely humiliated and there was going to be nothing I could do about it.
Oh, I thought he was putting that trash can over your head.
So did I. And how do you survive that?
No,
yeah. How do you come back from that? How
there's
do you
no
go,
dignity.
How do you go out in public?
You have to sit there and just pretend you're meant to be like the square. I can't think of that fucking thing's name. Bob Cunt Squarepants.
Oh,
shit.
SpongeBob.
SpongeBob Squarepants. You know?
You could take the garbage pail off of you, but your dignity is in there with the trash, never to come out again.
And then there's like milk and whatever else we've thrown in the garbage pail since
all
6
rotting.
This morning, just kind of falling from my hair. Sam.
Yeah, man. Hey, Opie, that's not adrenaline. That's fucking pussy juice.
Yeah. I can't argue with you today, man. Dan from Wisconsin. What's up, Dan?
Hey, love this time of year, guys. Watching the Yule, Steve.
You know, when someone gives you a guard dog that, you know, to protect you and stuff, you know, it's okay to yank his chain every now and then, but you don't piss him off and pull his tail. I mean, he'll turn around and bite your hand clean off.
I want to make this perfectly clear that I'm not the only one that was involved in this thing.
Hey, all of you were poking him with sticks.
Not
Everywhere
me.
You had a sharp stick.
Not Jimmy.
Not I didn't
Jimmy.
Do any poking.
And not me.
Oh.
I learned a valuable lesson today.
Yeah, you all were giving him a gouge every now and then.
All right, Dan. Thank you.
You be careful now.
All right. Tony in the Bronx. Hey, Tony.
Hey, what's going on? Oh, why don't you strap on your scuba gear and... fight Master Poe underwater. I guess that's the only way you
want to fight. Take it a few feet underwater.
I wonder if he could fight as well as I can underwater.
Yep.
Punch it out, guys.
He'd kick your ass underwater.
Yeah, just grab you.
60 feet underwater? I would never even...
Fight as good as you can. You had one fight underwater with a Frenchman.
Well, how many fights have you had underwater?
None. But
Jim, how many fights
French
have you
guy?
Had underwater?
I've had about 4.
I could be the only man alive that has ever fought 60 feet underwater.
Battling your hog in the bathtub doesn't count.
Right. I got you. Come here, you.
Trying to get it out of the ducky before all the water drains.
All right, well, don't mock it unless you've...
One fight
unless you've tried
60
it.
Feet underwater with a French guy.
Yeah.
What kind of fight is a French guy going to put up?
Not a good one, but
yeah.
Slow motion fighting rules. It really does. Dave in Indianapolis. What's up, Dave?
I was just wondering, isn't there anything in that 30 minutes of paperwork that the guests fill out that would protect Master Paul from a lawsuit?
Oh, I see. Nah, it was, you know what, that started out as just, you know, a fun little thing, you know, this guy wants to fight Master Po for a MiFi. We actually weren't going to have Master Po fight anybody. We know,
no, we just want to hear the guy talk.
We know that would be a bad idea.
We want to hear the caller, the guy that offered to fight. We want to hear him talk some smack, that's all.
That's it. And then it turned into a big thing because Anthony decided to make believe we were still on the air. It just amazes me. Listen to the replay yourself, you'll hear it.
Yep, listen to the replay. You will hear Opie say... No, we're off the air.
And then you'll see, too bad you can't see Anthony lean back in mock casual relaxing thing to make him lower his guard. Yeah, I forgot about that, how you were all leaned back.
Shut up!
That was your after show posture, his arms
over
his head.
I was stretching.
Yeah, leaning back, but being able to reach forward just enough to hit a couple of those buttons in front of you.
Oh, thank you for the hanging out to dry. What about Opie?
How long before we go to break? 2 minutes?
Yeah.
We got 2 minutes before we go to the break?
My acting.
Or come back for a break?
Too.
It worked well enough.
Yeah, all right. So.
Oh, the leaning back thing. Stop
yeah,
it.
You really were. Your hands behind your head just to
totally
disarm him.
Sold me out right there. I didn't hear Jimmy Norton go, no, we're on the air still, Master Poe.
Jimmy Norton's a good actor. He took his headphones off like he was on break.
Oh, you took your headphones off,
I believed
Steve.
It. I thought we were in a break.
You oh, did not.
Stop it.
All right, I'm going to make it perfectly clear that Anthony
wants
to talk to Brian, not me.
Let's see, just hear what Brian has
to
say.
Well, why don't you say hi to Brian?
Hello, Brian.
Yo.
Hi. Are you actually the guy that wrote in and wanted to fight Master Poe?
Yes, I am.
Ah.
Yes, I am. I could give you my email address and everything.
Thanks for starting a little bit of crap on the show.
That's what the hell happened? Because I
infighting.
I got.
Well, what happened was that I was almost paralyzed, and Anthony was almost thrown through a window and and would have fell probably 6 to 7 stories to his death, thanks to you.
My bad.
Well, and Norton would have just skated out of here.
Yep.
I'd like to know where's Brian's from?
Connecticut.
He's from Connecticut, and what are your fighting qualifications, sir?
Qualifications? Well. I've done a little MMA here and there, mixed martial arts for those who don't
MMA.
Know.
MMA?
Yes.
Mixed martial arts.
Yes. And probably not as much as Poe, but like I just want to prove that I could probably hang in there with him for a few minutes, win the MiFi, and you know.
All right, all kidding aside, there's no way you can hang in there with Master Poe. We've seen the guy in action. Look at me kissing Master Poe's ass now, but it's the truth.
Are you a big guy or you're like a wiry guy that could kick some ass?
No, about 6'1", 210.
We've seen Master Poe spar, and it's pretty ugly.
I'd spar with him any time.
Yeah, I don't know if we can get this done.
We can't, only because if he hurts you, and he probably will, that's what he was talking about with lawsuits. He'll get sued because he's here to protect, and all of a sudden, you know, we have him ripping people's arms out and smashing them with it.
I usually end up hurting someone real bad.
Yeah.
Well, hey, you know what? If I had to sign a waiver, I'll sign a waiver, whatever.
All right, Yellow Belly.
Harvey. All right, well,
Harvey.
It's a thought. We'll see what happens with that. We got your info, all right?
All right, dude.
All right. Well, there's the guy that started all the trouble.
Hey, get a load of fat soda.
Rock. And we got Shannon, we're calling her. Author of The Best You'll Ever Have, What Every Woman Should Know About Getting and Giving Knock Your Socks Off Sex.
So is it going to be the whole... Hi guys, how you doing? The perky, very up.
I think she'll be very businesslike.
You think?
Yes.
I think they have to be like, hi, well, this book is going to teach everyone what they really need to know to spice it up in the bed. Shut up!
How many copies of the book do we have, Ben?
Just one.
That's good.
Yeah.
Oh. Let one person peruse it while the two just
wing
it.
Oh, my God. You know what? I love this new bit. It's a Jimmy bit.
Tearing the pages.
Yeah. I want to.
I do love that bit.
I love this bit. And they don't understand what's going on.
Oh.
Thanks, buddy.
Yes.
Oh, wait. Jimmy, can I have that book? I think we have our sexpert line here.
Let me just I'm just perusing the Sharon and Mullen. Cool.
Hold on. I got to see the book. All right. No, I don't. We're trying to get her on the phone right now.
All right.
This is a little, like a one sheet on the best you'll ever have, what every woman should know about getting and giving Knock Your Socks Off Sex by Shannon Mullen. Here you go. This is the picture.
And I do believe we have her on the line. It's Shannon Mullen, right? Shannon?
Yep.
Welcome Hi, Shannon. To the Opie and Anthony program.
Welcome to the program.
Hi. Thanks for having me on.
Oh, no problem. When we found out that we were going to have you on the show, we got quite excited.
Oh, yeah.
We really did. We love sex.
LOL.
Who doesn't is right, you know? So what's going on there, Shannon?
Not much.
The book is called The Best You'll Ever Have.
Yep. With a very, very long subtitle.
Well, yes. Well, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Hi, this is Connor. It's myth number one. You have a section here on sexual myths?
Uh-huh.
What is this about? Tush sex is for gay men.
Oh. Yeah, that's a big myth.
Oh, I thought you were saying
that
it was...
Oh, that's a myth.
Hold on.
Yeah, that's a myth.
I thought you were saying that it was. I thought you were saying that it was actually only for gay men.
No, no, that would be part of the myth list.
Oh, so okay. That's something that is a knock your socks off type of sex.
Yeah, that's actually something that I think people ought to talk about more. For women, they think, well, why would I want something up my butt when I have a perfectly good vagina?
Right, exactly, especially if you're going to hit logs.
Yeah, so you have to kind of think it through and think. Why that makes sense in order to convince yourself to give it a go.
And why does that make sense?
Like it.
Yeah, why does it make sense there, Shannon?
It makes sense for women because there's a muscle called the PC muscle that goes from your pubic bone to your tailbone, like a hammock.
Mm-hmm.
And all of that muscle is filled with nerve endings. Every human being who has an orgasm has their butt twitch, you know? It's all connected.
Anthony and I have this thing, though. We think butt sex should be left for the young. How old is too old to have butt sex?
Right.
For the young only.
Yeah.
What about when you get old? You're going to be taking this.
You're a bit saucy. You're a bit saucy for our program, but that's okay.
There's actually a good line here, too. This is pretty funny. It's about the G-spot, and it says here, the search party begins. Hold on, what page is this? It says, break out the rubber gloves, kidding, about looking for the G-spot. Now, hold on, what page? This is page 51.
Yeah.
Is that a problem that most men have?
Finding the G-spot? That's a problem most women have, too.
So where is this G-spot?
Yeah, I'll tell you, because I finally came up with a way to explain it that I think is pretty simple. But there's a picture in the book that you can't misunderstand.
What page? What page?
Yeah, what?
There's two pictures in a row. Let me just flip through.
Oh, hold on. I got it right here.
There's one with a finger.
With a finger? I have page 49. It's a diagram of the G-spot. Is that it?
That's right. 49 and 53.
Oh, two pages.
Hold on.
First you look at 49, then you look at
53. Let me get 49. Hold on. All right.
So we show it first, like in relationship to what everyone knows. Everyone knows the uterus and the ovaries.
Right.
Because we had that in school. So if you're going to explain anything, you have to show that.
Uh-huh.
It says here the G-spot. It also has a picture of the bladder.
Yes, exactly. The bladder. Because at least we still have the bladder in our heads. Not uh-huh. Much.
Right.
And so, for women, the only thing they really remember is the tampon diagram.
True that.
Oh, yeah.
Every box of tampons comes with one of those.
Who doesn't
that
know
diagram
that?
Diagram sucks.
So how do you find the G-spot? You shove a couple fingers in there, and then what do you do?
Well, I would start with just one.
Just one.
Shock.
That's true. Yeah. You don't need to lose your babysitting job right away.
You can reserve the rest of the hand for other activities.
Right.
So it's through that.
The motion is the come hither motion.
Yeah.
Come over here.
Yeah.
So when you're doing that, stop halfway through and take a look at your hand from the side, and you'll see you're in like a perfect C shape.
A perfect C shape.
It's like 2.5 inches in toward the belly button, right?
It's towards the belly button side, and it's very, like you said, like 2.5 inches. It's the bottom one-third, so it's not very far in. And if you press on the pubic bone, which is really the base of your jeans zipper, everyone has a pubic bone.
Yes, we do.
But behind the pubic bone for women is the G-spot. So you're trying to get behind that bone.
It's quite spongy, right?
It is. It's like a ridgy, spongy... it's erectile tissue. So if she's in the right frame of mind, the G-spot's there and you can feel it. And if she's not in the right frame of mind, if she's nervous or uptight and just not ready yet, it won't really be very prominent. And the main thing for women is they've filled it here and there, but it makes them nervous because it makes them feel like they're going to pee. So a lot of times they'll feel it and they'll seize up and stop everything. instead of knowing they're not going to pee, being able to relax. So women tend to lose their best orgasms to fear of peeing. Right.
I like to call that G-spot Connor's headrest.
Headrest.
Now, our old Connor here in the studio.
I know. I always. I'm afraid to go swimming though. The book here now. Are you actually? Is it released yet?
Yeah, it just came out.
Oh,
time for Christmas.
Where can you get it?
Barnes and Noble, Amazon. I think your local bookstores carry it.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Well,
this Tush Talk. There's actually. I'll say one thing. I like the. There's a tremendous amount of like little headings at the top of every page. So it's kind of like almost like a food for thought type of book.
Oh.
Like, you know what I mean? Like you want to go out and go fishing or something with your mom. And, you know, if you're going to go fishing and maybe only one comes back and two don't.
Right.
How about here? It says, don't hate, masturbate.
Oh.
That's a pretty good story.
What's that about?
I started this business called Safina.
Right.
About 2 years ago. And Safina is the in-home sex ed salon for women. And we sell sex toys.
Oh.
But we call them accessories
for your lust life. Like accessories, but only sex.
Right.
I get it.
Right, accessories for your lust life. I mean, the whole thing about sex in America is still, it's very awkward and uncomfortable, like tush talk. I mean, the reason we call it that is so you can actually talk about your butt without feeling like a weird person.
Without feeling dirty.
Well, no one wants to listen to their tush. Plus, its breath stinks.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, all right. Well, what else do you cover that could help us out in the bedroom?
Well, sex toys are something that almost every woman is interested in, but they need permission to like them. So if you're married or you're in a long-term relationship, you really should get some, but make sure they're attractive. Don't buy ugly things.
Sharon, what's the difference between a clit and a penis?
Oh, that's a good question.
What page is that? I'm sorry to interrupt you, Shannon. What page is that?
Let's see. That's in the second chapter.
Connor wants to follow along in his own book.
Yes.
Like he followed along his mom to the depths of... well,
that's good. It starts off explaining kind of where the clitoris is and what it's...
Hold on. Let me just...
I'm looking for the diagram. This is a great diagram of the difference between a clitoris and a penis.
What page?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. What page? I'm trying to follow along in the book here.
Still looking for... Okay, here's a good page.
I gotta take the
94.
Hold on, the cover keeps falling off. Hold on.
All right, 94. We're at page 94 here. All right.
But you'd be surprised at how similar the clitoris and the penis are.
Really?
In fact, they're almost exactly the same.
Well, if they're on Jamie Lee Curtis, they are.
Even on your most average woman.
Well, Susan, obviously there's a difference in size, though.
I don't have a page here.
There is a big difference in size, but they operate exactly the same way. You know, everyone starts off female. This, I thought, was very surprising when I started this research. At the seventh week, if you've got a Y chromosome, your vulva closes up and it becomes testicles and the clitoris grows.
Oh.
So everyone starts off the same. So we actually have all the same exact stuff. And the clitoris operates exactly the same as the penis. So when blood rushes to the region,
yes,
the clitoris raises up and gets erect and sticks out from its foreskin.
How did you learn all this?
This took me about a year and a half.
That's it?
Well, that's all I did. I interviewed doctors, urologists, dominatrixes, you know, people who know things.
Really?
Let me ask you a question. Right here, I'm looking at page 150. It says, I've never had an orgasm.
Yeah. These are stories of real women.
Why are you laughing at that? Some girls don't have an orgasm.
I don't believe it.
A lot of people.
Yeah, exactly.
A lot. Look, it was like my dad. Less than 10%.
My dad and mom would always fight, and she would always. Like, my mom and I were talking one time. I actually just heard the fight from inside the little room I was staying in. That they, like, she would never have orgasms.
Right.
I mean, I heard this. It was kind of embarrassing as a kid to hear that. But it's like, I think times have changed now. Well, I think men are more in tune with making a woman have an orgasm. Am I right or wrong?
See, Connor's very interested in your book and learning all he can. I mean, I just know he's soaking up every bit of information he can and just tearing through it.
Yeah.
That's good. That means he's actually interested in women. That's good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I am. I'm very attached to my mother.
Because this orgasm thing is not a small problem. I mean, when I say 10%, I think I'm being conservative.
So, wow.
Wow.
Safina, what...
What kind of advice could you give to the ladies that don't get the orgasms there?
Yeah, orgasms really do start in mind.
Uh-huh.
What's that? I couldn't hear. It's very, very important to relax.
Just relax.
And that's
combo.
Most of the time, if you haven't had an orgasm by the time you're in your 20s, you're pretty frustrated.
Can't you just get them really...
Combo.
Can't you get them just really drunk? Will that help?
Oh, what about alcohol?
It really can't hurt. I mean, yeah, as long as you're not doing anything related to the butt.
Let me ask you,
you should never be drunk or high. That's a really bad idea.
Never be drunk or high for the butt.
That's the only way I could take it. Is tush sex bad for you? Like, for instance, I used to date one girl.
That's another myth.
Shut up.
Yeah, because people think, wow, you know, that doesn't seem like it ought to happen, and because in our culture it seems so bad.
Yeah.
And they think, well, what if I get all stretched out of shape and I'm in pain?
Yeah.
Right.
But if it's done properly, with lots of lube and going very slowly.
Right.
Yeah.
It's just another muscle you're exercising.
But if she's crying and saying no.
Yeah, then you probably better quit. right then.
Really?
Should you stop or should you put the diaper back on?
Absolutely.
I know. Better. He's being silly.
Yeah.
Oh, Connor.
I'm Sarah. Sarah?
No, Shannon.
Oh, Shannon. OP. Yeah.
Safina is the company and Shannon is
me. Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I've been calling you.
Amber was the mistress.
Let's see. The male G spot equals the P spot.
Yeah, P dash
spot. What does that mean?
The P spot is pretty interesting because, like I was saying, the clitoris and the penis are the same. Mm-hmm. Well, men have a G spot too, of course, because we have all the same stuff. Yeah. It just moves around. So, where the G spot is right behind the pubic bone and you make this come hither motion, the P spot is just a little further back and it's on the backside of the prostate.
So you're saying that men and women are pretty much the same before we're born, but it's just some type of a chromosome thing?
Yep.
All right.
And so everything just shifts around.
What makes women a little bit smarter than we are?
Connor, they sure are.
They sure are.
We know who the boss at home is, unless you have a motor and a boat. Then we teach you. Wow.
Yeah, one little blonde hair in the front seat. Dad didn't think.
Okay.
Well, I do have a theory about happiness. I'd love to try it out on you.
Hold on.
Little experiment.
If you agree.
Well, hold on. Okay.
Yes.
Here's my theory.
All right.
The reason why I focus on women with Safina and getting them to buy sex toys is because I think that if women think something's a good idea and so then we can all do it.
Yeah.
And so that if women are having fun, then we can all have fun.
Right.
So my theory is that women are in control of the fun and that women control happiness.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I have to agree with you. I think you're right.
Yeah?
Yeah. You seem to have culled a lot of knowledge from a lot of people and put it together very nicely in this book.
Well, thanks.
What have you learned on your own through your own sexual experiences?
Wow, a lot. I think I've learned a lot. Well, I found the kazoo is really distracting.
What's that?
The kazoo is really distracting.
Shoes are distracting?
Is that the kazoo?
Kazoo? What are you talking about?
Oh.
Something must be bleeding through. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, okay. I was hearing this Christmas music.
We were having
Christmas music. No, actually, we don't play Christmas music on our show.
Ever?
Yeah, because we figure all the other radio stations are doing that.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Okay, that's good. Okay. So
I don't know what that was.
We had some equipment problems earlier, and we do apologize for that.
Oh, that's okay.
Shannon,
that's
if something was bleeding through from a production facility.
I'm gonna spit this up your ass.
Well, but I poop from there.
What?
I found my G spot and I lost it and I found it again.
You did?
Yeah, I lost it for like 7 years.
Where'd you lose it?
You lost your G spot?
Yeah, I actually thought it was attached to this guy I was dating. And when we broke up, you know, I thought, wow, that was so great. I really.
For 7 years?
Yeah, nobody else was able to find it.
Seven years.
It was horrible.
The G-spot doesn't work.
Like breaking a mirror and then having bad luck, you know?
Yeah.
So I found my G-spot because I finally found another guy who could find it. And then I realized it wasn't attached to him.
Where was it? Was it at the mall?
Oh, girl.
It was under the couch cushions.
Oh, Connor.
Oh, my.
He's buried.
Jiminy Cricket.
Oh, boy. All right. Well, listeners,
have a few questions, I think, right?
Great.
Yeah, they're very excited to talk to a
sexpert.
A sexpert, right?
Do you call yourself a sexpert? What is your title?
I'm a sexpert now. I'm actually the new sexpert for iVillage. So I'm ordained as a real sexpert now.
What is iVillage?
iVillage is a women's website. It's like a kind of compilation of magazine articles from Cosmo and Book and all the major magazines and health issues and sex.
All right, let's go to Ken in... Hold on a minute. Let's go to Ken in Virginia.
Connor, stop it or you will not get your snorkel and flippers for Christmas.
Ken?
Yes, sir.
Do you have a question for the sexpert?
Absolutely. A couple of months ago, little Connor was licking a whore's ass, and he came down with a cold afterwards, and I was wondering if she found anything in her research that correlates the two.
Oh, yeah, that is true. Connor...
I was performing tushalingus.
Yeah. And,
tushalingus and got a cold?
And he got a cold. This is a true story, yes.
Is that possible, Shannon?
That's more than possible, but I don't know if it's related.
Okay.
Huh.
But if you only got a cold, you're lucky.
Well, you can't get anything from that. It can't happen to me.
All right.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy. We're all having a big laugh.
Oh, gosh.
What can you get from tushalingus?
Herpes is transmittable.
No, it's not.
From mouth to butt or anywhere.
Is eating logs bad?
I think you get something called stinkiest tongueiest. You know, stink.
But a cold, you got off easy. You could have gotten something bad.
All right. Why don't we say hi to Chris on Long Island? Chris, you got a question?
Hi. Good morning, guys. How are you?
Good.
Morning, Chris. Welcome to the program.
Thanks. Hi, Shannon.
Hi.
Hi. I just want to let you know that my wife has read a couple of books by Miss Frankel. She's a huge fan.
She's great, isn't she?
Yeah, yeah. And I have a question for you. You were talking about these accessories. And a friend suggested something. I wanted to know. My wife's teetering. Maybe I can push her over the edge. How do you feel about... I'd like her to defecate on a plate, preferably.
On a plate?
Yeah. And then, you know, maybe she could microwave it. And when it gets nice and hot, run around the house with it yelling, donkey sausage. Have you heard of this before, this donkey sausage phenomenon?
No, what's that?
Oh, well, it's this new thing, and it's really great. You just run around with a plate full of, hot steaming defecation, running around yelling, donkey sausage, you know, and it's supposedly a great turn-on, but my wife hasn't, you know, she's kind of on the edge. She doesn't want to try it.
Hmm. Well, that's a good question. Shannon, donkey sausage, yay or nay?
Well, you have to think of, to get anyone to do anything, especially with sex, you have to think what's in it for them.
Right.
So
right.
Now why is that going to be fun for her? You have to figure something out.
Shut up!
I think you have to come up with a reason why that's going to be fun.
Right. Well, that's a great question. I think it's some type of fetish thing he was into. Right.
Yeah, like if he wants to put down plastic bags on the floor and maybe have someone come over this afternoon at 5:30 and, you know, drop a few logs, 350.
All right, let's go to Eric in Manhattan. Eric, you have a question?
Yes, I do.
All right.
Quite often I have sex with my wife in the balloon knot.
Yeah.
And when I pull out, I have a little surprise. Is that safe, and how do I clean that?
I think what he's saying is he pulled his to say it right, it's tush sex, and he pulled it out, and it looked like his mule was wearing an Abe Lincoln hat.
Yeah.
Old gravy legs.
Right. Well, one thing's for sure, if she feels like she's got to go to the bathroom, she does. So she ought to consider that before you start, because that's, you know, it's really not a holding area.
Right. It's not a holding area.
No. So there really should be almost nothing in there.
Yeah.
Under normal conditions. So you should probably ask that. Okay. In advance.
Well, that's some good advice,
good question,
I must say.
Good question. Yeah. Serious questions only from our listeners,
Who's this now?
Vivid Empire.
Hey, what's up?
Hi. I want to know if this is considered a glass coffee table book, and what is the best way to introduce scat to the woman?
Is this considered a coffee table book?
No,
a glass coffee table book.
A glass coffee table book.
You can lay under it and read it.
Right.
Well, listen to...
Yeah, it's not big enough.
Chuck Berry
records. It's not one of those big books, so I don't know. But it is... It does have like a really cheerful, chiclet-looking cover.
Right.
So you could read it on the subway, and nobody's going to think anything.
And what was the second part of your question?
What was the second part?
what's the best way to introduce scat to my wife?
Scat.
Like the old, what, the old singing?
I don't know.
My chest is a...
Old gravy chest.
Old gravy chest.
Having the girl, like release herself number two on the chest.
What?
Oh, yeah. Is that what that is?
Is that what scat is?
Yeah, I think
wow.
so.
The euphemisms are amazing, huh?
We're trying to keep it clean
for broadcast. That's
Dude, is that what scat is, when someone uses your chest as a bowl?
Yeah, so you could even sculpt it, too.
Huh. Hmm.
Sharon? Yeah.
I default back to the, why is it going to be fun for her? Because that's the only way to motivate anyone to do anything.
Well, right. maybe it's fun for her because the guy gets so turned on by his fetish.
And she knows that she won't go to bed with a blackened jaw.
Well, that's probably the second job, right? That's always an incentive.
Yeah, really.
I know, really, Connor.
Connor.
A good time. I mean, if she really thinks that's going to be fun for you, maybe she could be convinced. But that's going to be a long shot. You probably should find somebody who has the same interest.
Right.
All right, we only have time for a few more questions here. Let's say hi to, looks like, Andre. Andre? Oh,
hello, everyone. How are you today?
Hello, Andre. Hi. Thank you for calling the program.
Thank you, Care Bear. Shannon, are you there?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I have a question for you. I'm currently dating another man's girlfriend. I'm playing a bit of a devil myself, if you understand. But my question is that, when this gentleman, his name is Mark, when I have his girlfriend over and she is performing,
oral treats?
Yeah, all right. That's a good way. Oral treats on me. She tends to have a bit of a gag reflex very quickly. And I want to know how to kind of maybe work her out of that so I can perhaps push a little more down, if you understand what I mean. You understand what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah, how do you get the girls to open their throats?
Yeah, because this one, she seems to not be able to take as much as I want to give her a cunt. What do you think?
Yeah, well, maybe she's just not going to be able to. It sounds like she's already trying too hard, or she shouldn't be gagging. She should probably use her hand at the same time.
She does use her hand a little bit, but I try to push more, and not more than 2 or 3 inches go in, and then she tends to have... You know, a tough time with that cunt. I don't understand how I can maybe get her to be able to accept more without kind of, you know, having a gag reflex or what do you think?
Yeah, well, if it's too much, it's too much. Maybe it's just too much.
But there's nothing I can do
because
to try to
gagging is just
help
a reflex.
Her get past that?
So she has to, she can use her hand at the same time. But obviously it's going too far. She wouldn't be gagging because gagging happens pretty far back.
Yeah.
Maybe she has a too small mouth.
Yeah. Andre? Is that it, Andre? Andre.
He punched out.
Or his phone may have went out. It sounded like a cellular.
All right. Well,
that was very good. Good question. Good answer. We got a couple of more.
Yeah, let's go to Scott in California.
Scott in Modesto.
Modesto. Scott?
Yes. Hi, Lil Connor.
Hi.
Hey there. I had a question for Shannon. I got in a little bit of legal trouble, Shannon. Because my wife really wouldn't shut the hell up, and Connor, you were there. You remember that, right?
I do.
Yes, it was a really. She was a pain in my ass. And see, Shannon, I'm surrounded only by guys now because of my little legal trouble, and because Amber's gone and my wife is well not with us. So I was just wondering, now that I'm surrounded by guys, how should I go about satisfying my desires?
Surrounded by guys. You're in prison?
Yeah, he's in prison.
Oh, okay.
He calls our program a lot.
Yeah.
Okay. I was trying to picture this.
I know. He's been in for about a year now.
And a lot of the things that he enjoyed doing, fishing, things like that, he's not able to do anymore. So I guess he wants to enjoy himself.
Is it normal to go gay because you're in prison, I guess, is what he wants to know.
Well, you know, the spectrum of kind of straight to gay is this continuum. And through history, men tended to be kind of gay before they got married. You know?
Really?
Yeah. Huh. And if you look at ancient Greece and lots of parts of the world, even now, it's considered like a normal boys' activity that you have. Cool.
So it's not gay if you're single?
Yeah, I think the definition of gay and straight is all what you decide to call yourself.
Well, it's not gay if you don't push back.
Whatever makes you feel like, oh, that's okay.
I don't know if it's, like, whatever you call yourself, but, I mean, there are labels, I think, that make some kind of sense, right?
Yeah, there are. I mean, people who are not interested in having sex with the opposite sex, ever,
Yeah, that's on the far end of gay. But right. Most shit dicks. Somewhere in the middle.
Somewhere in the middle. So,
Freddy Krueger, Rob Halford.
You could go out with girls, but then on the other hand, you're equally as comfortable maybe putting a java log in the fireplace and having a glass of wine with another man in your pajamas.
Let's relax.
Perhaps. And that's absolutely acceptable.
Well, you know, I think if we didn't have social taboos around being gay, more people would be more fluid about it.
I agree.
Right.
I agree.
But do you think that's a bit faggoty, the scenario that Anthony faggoty? Just described?
Yeah, two men just hanging out, watching TV with a fire going in their pajamas maybe, glass of wine.
Some cheese and crackers.
Cheese and crackers. That sounds like a nice kind of
that's
almost
a date.
It's a date, right?
That's a real date.
Yeah, that's what we were thinking. Kind of sounds like a date.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden the firemen show up. Oh, it's fantastic. It's fabulous.
Then that's a porn film.
Fabulous.
Yeah. All right. Why don't we go on to the next question? It's Bill in New Hampshire. Bill, you have a question for the sexpert.
Oh, Shannon?
I mm-hmm. sure do. Hey, O&A. Nice. Hey, Sugar Nut.
Hi.
All right. Bill, what do you have for Shannon?
Well, something I've been feeling really weird about for a long time when I was young.
Okay.
I used to kind of experiment with my friends. We'd hide under a porch and play silly games.
The whole circle jerk thing?
What do you mean silly games?
Well, we'd get under the porch and, you know, we'd kind of gobble each other up a little bit. I'd rest my head on my friend's thigh and we'd just go from there.
What?
Did you have any weird name for this thing?
No, it sounds like a circle jerk with oral sex.
Oh.
Well, we called it Monster Rain.
Monster Rain?
Monster Rain?
What kind of a sick idiot would come up with a name like
that?
What
is that?
Why Monster Rain?
What does the rain have to do with it?
Yeah. Helen, what do you think of that?
Well, it was a good excuse to get under the porch.
Oh, so
we would pretend it was raining monsters.
Oh, so the rain was coming. You guys would hide under the porch and then kind of give each other oral favors?
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Huh. It's little kids blowing each other. Where do you stand on that?
Helen, is that normal?
Seems like a thing. Yeah, it seems perfectly normal. I think Monster Rain is pretty creative, but...
Yeah, there you go. Pretty
creative.
I feel
a lot better about myself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, how old are you when you and Jimmy Robinson don't do that anymore, Helen? How old are you?
How old am I or how old was
that? No, I'm asking the sexpert. How old is that not be when you're not normal anymore for doing that?
Well, I don't know if you're ever not normal for it. I mean, because then you just
become the Bible
gay.
Says different. Huh?
At some point, you just cross over into gay.
All right.
Right,
you know,
right.
Once you've hit puberty.
God
and,
willing.
You know, then you're just seeing guys instead of girls under the porch.
Yeah,
no, that.
Yeah, but that seems like a normal kid thing.
Yeah, Bill, don't worry about it. Thank you for the question.
Yeah, that's...
Bill.
I like that one, actually. Let's go to New Mexico and talk to Mike. Mike, what's going on?
Not a whole lot. How's it going on, eh?
Good. We're enjoying Shannon. Shannon Muller?
Mullen.
Mullen. I'm sorry.
What's happening there, sweetie pie?
Hello, marmalade bag.
Oh, yeah. Shannon, I got a question for you.
Great.
Shannon.
Yep.
Oh, something must have happened to his phone.
Uh-oh.
Did we lose New Mexico? Yeah, okay. I don't know what that was. Sorry, Shannon. Let's go to...
And he had asked, Shannon, it was going to be a good question or something.
Yeah.
And he lost them.
It could have been a good one. Now we're all going to be wondering what he was going to say, which is always uncomfortable. Lil Jimmy is calling from New York. Yes, Lil Jimmy?
Hey, Opie Anthony. Lil Connor, how's it going?
I've been better. I'm kind of wet behind the ears.
Oh, that's terrible. Well, let's give you a little background information. I'm a 35-year-old aspiring comedian. And I enjoy Ladies of the Night occasionally.
Really?
And the problem is...
You know, you're an aspiring comedian. Can we see you anywhere?
Actually, you can see me at the Downtown on December 23rd.
That would be what? This Thursday night, huh?
That would be.
Okay.
Go to my website, eatabullet.com, if you'd like to see my luscious body.
Are you going to hopefully be funny?
Oh, I will kill. I'm ready to go.
Or is it going
to
be the same old crap that you're known for?
Oh, why do you got to do this to me on radio?
Sean, I'm just joking. We kind of know this guy. He's a local comedian, and he's a meaty disaster.
Connor, you have something to add to
Jimmy? Yeah, if you want to go see Lil Jimmy, you can see him and Nathaniel, who's headlining, at 516-293-7700. That's the Downtown Long Island. A little plug for you, Lil Jimmy.
Thanks a lot. I'm going to come to you in, actually.
All right.
Shannon, if you'd like to come too, it's on me.
Cool.
Yeah, that sounds like fun.
Well,
yeah.
Well, my problem here is that I enjoy my ladies at night like usual, and I have a hard habit of laying on my back and having them urinate on my throat. I need to get over this habit because I'm running out of money. My mother's getting very distraught over this situation.
You told your mother about that?
My mother actually left a message on my answer.
Oh, my God. You know what? Oh, my God. Okay, yeah. Shannon, we do have that phone call.
Oh, no, please don't.
We do have that phone call, but...
Shannon, we'd love to play this. It's a message that Lil Jimmy's mother left Lil Jimmy on his phone.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about ladies of the evening and maybe what Jimmy could do to, stop seeing them so much.
How interesting. Let's hear it.
Yeah, maybe you can add some insight.
Yeah, I mean, you're the sexpert. I mean, you know, what does Lil Jimmy Norton's mom know about prostitutes, right?
My face is red.
Let's give a...
All right, hold on, Lil Jimmy.
Oh.
And there it is, Lil Jimmy's mom. Isn't that sweet? Lil Jimmy,
really
thank you.
Sweet.
Thank you for sending that in and sharing with everybody. We greatly appreciate that.
But Shannon, what we were thinking is that what was Lil Jimmy's mom saying because of the fact she was saying Dr. Phil says to replace things and that he should go to the gym is that basically he's kind of fat-breasted and awful and that picking up prostitutes is probably the only option until he does a few crunches.
Well, she said that really nicely, if that's what she was saying.
Actually, I'd like to play right now a phone call that our own Connor's mother made to Connor.
Oh, yeah.
On the show.
Hi, Connor. It's Mom. Next stop, Davy Jones' locker.
Hello?
Is that it?
Yeah, I don't even know what that means.
Yeah.
Whew. I didn't get that. Yeah.
I didn't get it at all.
It's an old Sicilian message. They got diapers.
I don't get that either. So, well, any advice to Lil Jimmy as far as the hooker habit and the mom calling and all that?
He sleeps with the guppies.
Well, exercise is always a good idea, but it's not exactly equivalent to a urination test.
Right, exactly.
So probably that won't change what you feel like doing, but it's always good to get fit.
Okay. Does that help you, Lil Jimmy?
That really helps a lot, actually. I don't feel so bad about myself.
All right, very good. Thank you for calling the program.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Remember the downtown.
Bye, Lil Jimmy. See you at the downtown.
Yep.
See you later,
Thursday
Angel.
Night. We'll get to see him again. That's going to be great. It's going to be a great show. Hey, Greg in Vegas, we got to wrap up with
Shannon.
Shannon.
Hey, I got a question about pussy parts. Do I cry? Do I laugh? Do I hang a car freshener over it? Or what do I do?
What was the first part?
Pussy farts, Shannon. Where do you stand on
pussy
that?
Pussy farts. Well, there's air, you know.
But should girls feel silly, uncomfortable?
No,
should they just say, here it is?
Air moving around. And if the guy wasn't there, it wouldn't be making noise, you know?
Right,
good
right.
Point.
It's really the guy's fault for moving around.
Ah.
And so, no.
So your book now, when did it actually come out?
It just came out at the end of November. So it's been out for two, 3 weeks.
Two, 3 weeks.
Two,
two or three weeks. So we must have one of the first copies.
Yeah, one of the first copies.
Oh, thank
you.
Connor's loving it.
I think they sent you, like, early.
Why'd you only send one, though?
I don't know. The publisher did. I'm sure we can get you more.
Please do.
Oh, yeah.
I'm running out of pages.
Connor's going through it like crazy.
I'll get them to send you a couple more. Thanks.
He
so much
loves it, yeah.
All right. I don't know what this question is, so we'll
ripping right through it.
We'll try to figure this out together on the air. Zach from Tampa. Zach?
Hey, guys. How's it going? Hey, sweet tits.
Hi, Angel Face.
Like two callers ago, I love the ladies of the evening, and I picked up one recently. And as I was rubbing my hands over her back, I noticed it was kind of wide. And then I found some balls. Does Shannon have any suggestion for me on this?
Wow. Maybe you should talk to them a little bit more before you get them home.
Ooh, good, good. Ooh. Good suggestion.
Yeah.
Well, should you feel ashamed that you picked up a man when you thought you were picking up a female prostitute?
No, I wouldn't.
And what's the best way, you say, to, like, wash man breath off of your junk just in case, you know, something happened? Then you're getting this waft of man breath.
Yeah, and your friend up. Tyler is knocking on the bathroom door going, how was it? And you're in there washing shame off your mule.
Antiseptic soap.
Yeah, that's a little much. All right,
I guess so.
Well, we've learned a lot here today. Shannon, thank you.
Thanks so much.
The name of the book is The Best Years of Your Life.
And no, The Best You'll Ever Have.
Best You'll Ever Have, and you can get it in, I can't see that page.
Yes, Jimmy?
Yeah, where could you get it?
Connor?
Barnes & Noble, Amazon, any major bookstore.
Now, this is your first book?
This is my first.
Oh, wow. Congratulations.
Thanks.
It's got to be very exciting.
It is exciting. I hope people buy it and read it so I can write another one.
It's a real page turner. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. This was really good.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it.
Thanks very much. I'm going to have a book party. So if you're in New York,
you're welcome to come. Hold on one second.
What?
Another question? Where's the book party, Shannon?
Yeah, where's the book party going to be held?
The book party's going to be at Lotus.
What happened?
Yeah, but she got it out.
Damn. I know. You weren't able to hang up on her quick enough with these computer phones.
I thought she was going to give me an or something.
Click.
I know, you let her get all the information out.
Ugh, I blew it.
No, you didn't, but she still didn't.
All right.
You don't know when.
She got cut off. She's standing there talking into the phone.
Oh, hold on. Something happened to her phone.
Well, what happened?
Shannon?
I just disconnected.
What happened? So, the book party is going to be...
At Lotus. Hello?
Shannon.
Jesus. Is she going to call back? If she does, silent game.
All right.
Silent game.
Let's see, Bernie Getz is going to be on the show tomorrow. Are you kidding me?
I've been begging.
How great is that?
I want Bernie Getz.
Bernie Getz will be on the program tomorrow.
I think he might be coming in or calling in. We don't know.
All right, very good.
Coming in. Be great.
I know.
Make sure Earl is here tomorrow.
Huh? All right. Oh.
Shannon.
I don't know what's going on.
Sorry about that. So your book party is coming. Do you want to just, any final thoughts on the book?
Well, it's great for Christmas, so don't hesitate to get one at the holidays. But mainly, I'm interested in people telling stories. So if you do pick up a copy of the book, I hope you'll email me. And my email's in the book. Are you there? Hello? 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 Hello?
Hello?
Oh, oh. So, we're about to end the program.
Yep.
Okay.
We're about to play What Did We Learn on the Opie and Anthony Show. What did you guys think of Shannon? She was all right, huh?
Yeah.
Very good.
I thought she went on a little long, but it was all right. Well, it was a good segment.
I thought she was very nice, but she got like a little rude at the end. Like, I think she was pissed off at us. I don't know why she was unhappy with
us. No, I wasn't pissed off at all.
Kind of
weird.
I think she thought that some of the callers were making fun of her or something.
She
didn't have to have an attitude about it, you know.
No.
Gotta understand some of our listeners are just stupid.
She didn't really sound like an expert on sex.
Yeah, a lot of people are putting books out lately that just, you know, just to probably make a profit and rip people off.
Why'd she hang up on us?
I
think we treated her nice and she hung up on us like that.
No, I didn't hang up.
I was going to plug the book again, but if she's angry at us, there's no reason for her to be angry. I don't know why she hung up on us.
Angry.
I think that she probably
sounded so nice at the beginning of the call, and then at the end,
I thought we were having fun, but all of a sudden, she hung up a couple times. I was ready to call her, you know, a bitch or something.
I mean, I'm enjoying this book.
I didn't really want to go there, but I don't know. I didn't know what to do. All of a sudden, we were left out there with, you know, an uncomfortableness that...
I've never been hung up like that.
She hung up three times, man. It was like there's no reason for it.
Sometimes I understand we have phone problems, but for the most part...
had phone problems.
I don't know why she would do that.
And there was a couple...
Can you hear me?
She seemed nice at first.
Wow, the instant feedback, are calling her the C word for some reason.
Why? No. For what?
I don't think she was that bad. A little bitchy, maybe, but I wouldn't use the C word.
They could probably sense how, well, that was really rude to be talking. All of a sudden, she's gone.
I know, just hanging
up
like
there?
That.
Wait, she's there? Hello?
I'm here.
Shannon? Hello?
Yes, I'm here.